Hey guys. How you doing? How are you? Hey, now get out of here. That's an old one. From like last year. Our classic humor from 6 months ago or so. Welcome. We're going to be doing some interesting stuff today. And did you hear me clear my throat? Hope not. We're going to be watching some more infomercials. I have a bunch queued up here. We're not just going to do food this time. The first one seems very, very interesting, and I'm very curious how it plays out. Stream's not going to be more than probably a few hours today. I think that after like 2 or 3 hours of doing this, it's probably it. We need to take a break from the overstimulation of infomercials. Plus, I need to make sure I get something ready for tomorrow. Not for stream, but you know, for Jeremy. So I got some stuff going on tomorrow that I have to prepare for. So we'll be live for like a few hours. We'll see. Have I seen Morbius? No, and I'm never going to see Morbius. I'll probably have a dream about the movie Morbius, and that will count as me watching it. I think that... Is that fair? I think that's fair. What did you rate it? I don't know. What does everybody else say? What does it have on Metacritic right now? The exact score on Metacritic right now. The exact score. Yeah. 35%? I'd probably give it like a 30. I'd probably give it like somewhere in the 30s. Morbius is better than your streams, okay? But I have a multi-million dollar, like $100 million Marvel Studios project that had 5,000 people work on. Is better than me watching infomercials? But here's the thing, are you sure? Are you sure? I don't know. We'll see. Okay, then the YouTube title has to be Watching Infomercials is Confirmed Better Than the Morbius Movie, right? That's only if it's confirmed today. All right, I'm pretty much ready. Yes, it is confirmed. All right, let's get started. We're only here for a few hours, so let me clear my throat one more time because I'm fucking throat Andy. Hope you had a good sleep. Those of you that slept. What? What does that mean? Here you... Okay, hold on. All right, this one's called Amazing Discoveries Infomercial, The Human Calculator. Human Calculator. Apparently, it's for a product that teaches you how to do math really fast or something, and I thought, okay, I'm very curious. I need to know. Let's find out. You guys ready? Did you just wake up? No. Here we go.
Special program Amazing Discoveries is a paid advertising right,
Amazing Discoveries
in its entirety by Media Arts International. Coming up next on Amazing Discoveries, we'll show you how to turn on the human calculator in you.
Now, all right, here's the host. So how, I need to know this.
Mike Levy.
Welcome.
Holy
welcome.
Shit. That sweater is fucking insane. I love it.
Who is fondly referred to as the human calculator. You'll see why. Scott Flansburgh.
What he's here.
497 times 35. What is that?
17,395.
Whoa, they put him on the spot.
But there's more.
Hold on. They put him on the spot for that. 20. We're not going to watch all 28 minutes. Don't worry. Is this a game show? No, this is not a game show. This is in 30 seconds. They introduced the show, showed the guy, and gave him a gotcha question. And he got it immediately right. You guys ready?
Scott, here's a hard one. What's 4,379 divided by 7? What is that?
625.57142.
What? Wow. All right. What the fuck are you talking about?
Now, what? Obviously likes math. But let's be honest with ourselves.
Is there a
How
screen?
Many people in today's studio audience have been frustrated or intimidated by math? How many people here?
Me? I don't know shit about math.
But you know, the important thing is that if you don't pick up math young as a child, it can actually slow down or stop how far you can go in life. It can limit how much money you can make.
What the fuck?
And aren't we tired of hearing how America's educational system is falling apart? How other countries like Japan are producing smarter kids? Huh? Well, today's amazing discovery is going to turn all that around because our...
When did this come out? Like 1980 something? Like 80, like 3, 84? That statement, I remember, if you don't know math, you are gonna be fucked for the rest of your life. If you don't understand how to become a human calculator, you're gonna be eating out of a dumpster tomorrow. John?
Our special guest says that by the end of today's show, everyone in our audience and you at home are going to be able to do complex mathematical calculations, not on paper and not with an old-fashioned calculator, but in your head.
Okay.
Scott, how is this possible?
Mike, just keep an open mind because today I'm going to show you and everyone watching
how well, can we do this?
The power we have deep down inside us, and we just don't know how to turn it on.
That would be great. But before you get started, Scott,
if this works, let's do it.
We have one of our famous Amazing Discoveries challenges just for you. Are you ready?
I'm ready, Mike.
Okay.
Oh, this is to prove it.
Scott Flansburgh appeared on Gary Collins' home show. And by the end of the show, 22,000 people phoned in and admitted that they were poor in math. And we've invited four of them to join us here on today's Amazing Discoveries.
What?
And they're from across the nation.
Hold on a minute. He was on a show and they said, hey, if you suck at math, call in. And 22,000 people called in and said, hey, I can't do it. And they picked four of those 22,000 people. Okay, so I want to figure out my understanding how this played out here. Who cares? That's not a big deal.
And they're from Florida, from California, and even all the way from Alabama. Welcome, everyone.
Yeah, but I mean, this is not fair. This is a kid.
End of the show, 22,000 people phoned in and admitted that they were poor in math. And we've invited four of them to join us here on today's Amazing Discoveries. And they're from across the nation. They're from Florida, from California, and even all the way from Alabama. Welcome, everyone.
Okay, but now, how would you know all that math if you're like a kid?
By the end of today's show, he's going to have you all doing complex math calculations in your head.
I'm here, too. I would be number five.
Okay, Scott, go for it.
Oh, no, Mike, I'm not going to do it. I've got to do this show with you. So what I did was I brought a friend with me that's going to take him backstage during the show and teach him how to do everything.
Okay, bring out Scott.
What?
Kevin, come on out. I need Kevin.
What? Wait a minute. This is a little
Kevin's bad. A child.
You're going to train them?
Yeah.
Mike, I can't believe this.
Yeah, Mike, that's just it. This program is so easy, anybody can learn it. It doesn't matter how young or old you are.
Are you sure you can do this?
It's a piece of cake.
Okay, you're out of here.
Oh, that's a lot of pressure.
Trainer.
It's a lot of pressure, son.
I'll come back with you later and see how you're doing. Everyone here want to see some more demonstrations from Scott?
Yeah, okay. Let's see it. I want
to
see how this...
I'm
very curious.
He even listed the help of Ray Gayton. Now, Ray Gayton is a certified public accountant from a nationwide accounting firm.
They got like a tax attorney? Forrester,
and he's here to check Scott's accuracy. He's going to follow along with Scott using his adding machine here. And Scott...
This is an expense they didn't have to have. In this image right now... This man is holding a calculator. This guy and this guy doesn't need to be here. He has an adding machine. What is this? What the fuck is this thing? Is that a fudge brownie? What are you talking about? Why does this guy have to be here?
For every correct answer, you're going to hear this sound. But Scott, should you give us a wrong answer, Ray's going to give you one of these. Okay, thanks, Ray. And to give you some really tough problems, we have an entire Girl Scout troop here in our audience. Troop
tough number
1525 from Van Nuys, California. And they're going to give you some really tough problems, Scott. Are you ready?
I'm ready, Mike. But afterwards, I want to show everybody how easy it is and that anybody can learn how to do this.
Okay.
Did this cost money?
What is your name?
Patricia.
Let's give Scott a big, long row of three-digit numbers to add up. Give him 4 3-digit numbers, and Scott's going to add them in his head. Go ahead.
333.
Plus.
454.
That's 700.
Plus.
699.
Plus.
13. That's 14.
And okay. I got to give you one, too. Here's
that's 20.
984.
I don't know. This is stupid.
3,469.
Right up.
This is a calculator with paper.
Sure, Mike.
That was a calculator with paper in it.
Cassie, let's give him a hard division problem. How about a four-digit number divided by a single-digit number?
5,973 divided by 7.
853.285.
He's using the force. Hold on a minute.
Divided by 7.
Wait.
800.
Right here, this like I can hear the music.
53.285714.
Yeah, right. That's fucking impossible.
Mike, it's so easy. If I could you have the girl that gave me the addition problems? I want to bring her down here and teach her how to do it.
I want somebody to get like power bombed through that table.
When we normally
this table,
the numbers up,
this is the set table that is breakable. Let me just give you some insight here. This is made out of like plywood, like small thin sheets of plywood, and no supports. This is made for someone to go through this table. But I imagine somebody's gonna get annoyed with this guy, and they're gonna go at it, and he's gonna get like fucking choke slammed through this table. Yeah, it's like an Eric Andre table. Yeah. This is the I'm going to go through this eventually table.
And teach her how to do it. Okay,
so how do you do it?
Patricia,
when we normally add a column of numbers up, don't we start on the right hand side and then go to the left and carry and all that stuff? It's pretty difficult. But I want to show you a real easy way to get the answer, okay? Now, instead of starting over here, let's start on the left hand side. And this one right here, doesn't it stand for 100?
Yeah.
And what does this 2 stand for?
200.
Okay, so now let's keep a running total in our heads, okay? What's 100 plus 200?
300.
Plus another 100?
It's 400.
400.
Right, plus 200 more?
600.
Okay, now let's go to the top of the next column, which is the tens, right? So this 2 tens stands for 20, so add it to 600, and what do you get?
620.
Plus 20 more?
640.
Plus 20 more?
660.
Plus 10 more?
670.
Okay, now look, go to the top of the ones. What's 670 plus 3?
But this is like a lot to do in your head.
Plus 6 more.
679.
Plus 1.
680.
And 4 more.
684.
684, and that's the right answer.
Patricia!
What? No fucking way!
Let's hear it for Patricia.
But Mike, bring me the other girl down that gave me the real hard division problem. I want to show you
the division problem. Now this one is horseshit. I'm curious about this. This is horseshit.
Cassie, are you pretty good at multiplication?
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to show you a shortcut for real big numbers. Like, let's say we wanted to multiply 95 times 95, okay? Now here's how you do it. How far is 95 from 100?
5.
Okay, so what you do is you put minus 5 underneath, and what do you get? What's 95 minus 5?
90.
You had it, it's all right. And now take this number here and square it. What's 5 times 5?
25.
And right down here, and that's the answer to 95 times 95. 9,025.
Yeah, but this is, all right, well, hold on. But this is not.
You try one. 96.
That's not the problem he did, though. That's not the problem that she said. Wasn't it like a huge amount of fucking decimal points?
Square. That means 96 times 96. Now, how do you do it?
Okay, 96 from 100 is
4. 4?
Minus 4.
Keep
minus
watching
4,
it.
And what do you get?
92.
Okay, write that down. Now, what do I do?
Square the 4, which is 16, and put it after 92.
Great. And what's the answer to 96 times 96?
9,216.
That was terrific.
So what? But that's not the question.
Scott, these girls caught right on. Congratulations, girls. How do you do that?
Mike, I see thousands of kids, parents, and teachers every week.
You're learning.
Same results time and time again.
Well, we want to see those results for ourselves.
We want to see those results for ourselves.
And visited Choya Junior High School in Phoenix, Arizona, where Scott's been teaching his methods and having some pretty amazing results.
Wait, he's a teacher there?
All right, Nicole, we have your math book, and notice how I have to use a calculator for this. You ready? What's 462 plus 385 plus 517? What is that?
1,364.
That's correct. That's really good.
That was pretty easy, thanks.
That was
easy? Yeah. What do you mean easy?
All right, Kyle, what's 24 times 97?
2,328.
It's right. It takes me longer to put in the calculator. All right, Carly, your problem is 93 squared.
8,649.
I'm not through pushing. You're right.
This guy's great. I want
something different.
Shirts.
What is the cube root? And I didn't even know what a cube root was, let alone do the stuff in your head. Of 109.
Did they get this guy in a time machine? This is this person. Now, let's see if it works on me from fucking 40 years ago. It's the same person.
112. What's that, Zach?
58.
The same voice.
You did. Very good. Well, those kids.
This is the same person talking.
So we visited a woman who's devoted her life to math to discover why Scott's methods are so successful.
Dr. Mary Hatfield, you're an assistant professor here at Arizona State University, and you've been a director of the National Council of Teachers of Mathematics, representing literally thousands
he's
of
mathematics. Okay, the camera's going to pan, and he's talking to the lady over here.
Teaching teachers what to teach and how to teach. Now, I understand that Scott's methods are really very different than the traditional way of teaching mathematics, right?
Yes, they are. The traditional way is boring. It's
math. It's true. Math sucks. I fucking hate it. It's so stupid.
Doing something just the way the teacher tells you to do it. And Scott's way is to take those numbers and say,
put these numbers apart. If it works,
put
it works.
Back together. Try this, double this, square that, and all of those things.
All right, let's go.
Aunt Diana here to our studios in Los Angeles, and we're going to give Carla another tough problem. You ready? You ready, Carla? Okay, but just to show everyone that you have no calculators there, show them your hands.
She's not a magician.
No.
How is this a magician? She's not a magician.
Here's a tough one. I'm going to give you 73 squared. Now, 73 squared is 73 times 73.
You don't have anything up your sleeves?
5,329.
Like a fucking deck of cards?
Wow. You did it just as fast.
All right, where does this end up? Wait, we have an expert.
I hated math. I hated it through high school. I hated it in college. And I was so thankful.
So I fucking sued it.
Math at law school.
I sued it
and
lost.
I'm a litigator in
$40 million.
And I use math every single day.
Okay, how does this end?
We come back
by doing even the most difficult math problems in your head, often faster than a calculator.
1,858.
This has been a series of people saying large numbers.
What would happen when the teacher came over and slapped down a sheet of problems that Bobby finished these problems?
Well,
I feel like we've seen the whole thing already.
Hard, I would lay it down and I would go to sleep.
You'd go to sleep. You must have really hated math.
Yes, I hated it, Mike.
And Scott, I understand, showed you a new way to think about math, right?
Yeah.
What happened?
He taught us that it was easier for us to do it in our head than it was to do it on paper or the way they taught us.
Really?
Oh, wait, but hold on a minute. What, if you need to show your work, how do you do it? You can't do that, right? You'd have to, like, put it on.
And now you can do calculations in your head?
Digit, which is a 3.
We're finally across
America. I want somebody to go through that table.
That was the
side of you. 5 for shipping and handling.
Students drill and kill type activities, which is
sharp math skill. Ready?
Yeah.
Huh? What? What happened?
Mathematics for the entire state of
what
Arizona.
Happened?
K-125. Sharp math skills.
This power, you can do anything you want.
I think we all have to agree.
All right, human calculator. That was a pretty good one. That was a pretty good one. Let's keep going. I got a lot, by the way. This one is also not food related. This one is... The Martinettis bring home a computer.
The following is a paid advertisement by Apple Computer Inc.
This is a dramatization. All characters are... Why would you say that?
As far as I can tell, families have two kinds of people. The ones who want everything to stay the same, and the ones who want to spice things up a bit. I guess you can count me in the second group. Zoe,
why are you standing like that?
She's my sister.
I feel like I stand like that in pictures.
He's always up for something crazy. And Mom, she's a classic. Gramps loves opera, so you can count him in for sure.
I did all this on my computer.
And Schubert, he's just cool.
Schubert?
I guess in our family, it was only Pop who was really set in his ways.
Wait.
Of course,
who?
We all thought that was really set. I guess, and Schubert,
Schubert.
He's just cool.
Oh, is it the...
I guess in our family, it was only Pop.
Hold on, wait.
And Schubert loves opera.
Oh, it's the
so
dog.
You can count him in for
sure. It's like, is this guy's name Schubert? Like, that's interesting. Why are you calling, like, you calling Dad by your first, his first name? That's, that was kind of, that would be weird, right? Like, oh, and of course, my, you know, my dad, but I call him by his first name.
Schubert, he's just cool. I guess in our family, it was only Pop who was really set in his ways.
Okay,
of
Dad
course,
doesn't like computers.
We all thought that that would change once we got our new computer. I'm TJ. And this is the story about when my family, the Martinettis, brought home a computer.
Okay, so who, Grandpa is...
Getting a computer in our family was a real adventure. We're all so different, I never thought we could agree on one. Mom, you see, she runs a home business.
Hey, get off.
Hey, Mom.
That is when she's not running the home.
Did she say, hey, get off, get off the computer? Is that what she says?
She runs
hey,
a home
get off.
Business.
Get off.
Hey, Mom.
That is when she's not running the home.
Oh, she's kiddo.
Frank, he's the brains around here, studying to be an engineer or something like that.
I mean...
Zoe and Gramps, they're the Martinetti Philharmonica and Jug Band.
Allegro, honey. More Allegro.
Well, that's what Pop calls
oh, there's
him
a good, kindly old man.
As for Pop, he's got his own ideas about things.
Where's the sports?
But he's a great guy.
Never find.
Hey, Pop, check this.
That's pretty clever, TJ.
Yeah, Pop's understanding, supportive.
But no points.
Son, delete that. You fucking put that on Facebook either. Making our family look fucking stupid. Making me look like an idiot. Don't put that on Facebook. Is it already, how many likes does it have? 40? Okay. All right, if it gets to 50, I won't be upset.
And sometimes as stubborn as a mule.
No points. What do you mean, no points? It's a work of art here.
A work of art? Yeah, that's what everybody thought.
Oh, I like it.
No points.
Except Pop.
No, why saying no
points? I gotta tell you about
points.
And I gotta tell you how we weren't gonna keep the computer until we earned enough points to convince Pop we should.
The world got along fine for thousands of years without computers.
The world got along terrible.
And that's because there was no Tetris.
You hear that? Exactly.
See what I mean? I better go back to the beginning, though.
Okay, but...
Because it's a wild story. And you really gotta know our family.
Oh, this game's awesome. This game's amazing.
I guess it all started the night I came home late from school. Sorry I'm late, you guys. I was finishing up my report at the computer lab at school.
Oh. Well, since when's our typewriter not good enough for reports?
Our typewriter.
Pop, he can do all kinds of stuff on the computer he can't do here.
Like?
I use the electronic encyclopedia, the internet. I put pictures and words together. The thing is, Pop had a computer.
He's not even paying attention to his
and
son.
About all he ever did was put numbers into it. I don't blame him for not wanting one of those.
He's daydreaming?
He didn't know there was a whole other
Hold
world
on, wait. He's
the electronic encyclopedia, the internet. I put pictures and words together. The thing is, Pop had a computer at work.
He's just like, he's not even listening.
And about all he ever did was put numbers into it. I don't blame him for not wanting one of those. But he didn't know there was a whole other world out there. Hard disk drive, it's really cool.
I hear you can even get music on the computer.
Opera?
Sure, Gramps, and pictures, too.
Well, you can do that on a computer?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, hey.
The kids could really use...
Nothing has changed, by the way. Nothing. Zero. This was like 20 or 30 years ago. The exact same conversation happens. That, like, wait, what do you mean a computer? What's a computer? It's, I mean, 30 years have gone by. That this is this always going to be like this? Like, when I get to be, like, 80, am I going to look at grandkids and stuff and be like, wait a minute, what is a computer? You could do that on a computer? What's a computer do? Like, is the old people always just don't understand? I feel like, is that what's going to happen? Like, even though I've been using computers, like, my adult life, right? Am I just not going to know?
Use a computer, Lou. Maybe even you and me.
Yeah. I don't know, Mayor. What if we get one and we don't use it?
Well, we could just look.
I want one.
Me too.
No promises.
So that's how the great computer quest began.
Grandpa's demanding.
Of course, Pop said that before we did anything, we had to talk to an expert.
Well, who do we know that knows a lot about this kind of stuff?
Fletcher.
Oh, is it gonna be like a hacker?
Next day, we went to see Fletcher. Fletcher was what Pop would call a piece of work. He was Frank's friend, a real genius.
Look at this store.
He sold computers. There he is.
Whoa, the whole Martinetti family. Wow.
Fletcher, look at these monitors.
We're thinking about buying a computer. Tell Pop it's a good idea.
Oh, it's a good idea. Now, I could sell you something expensive, Mr. M, but I won't.
Thanks, Fletcher. Now, what do you
expensive.
Got?
Expensive.
Well, let's see.
It's EB games?
You'd be interested in a computer the whole family could use, right?
Right, yeah.
Something with multimedia.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, we have a lot of PC clones in stock.
PC clones?
PC?
Ugh! On sale. Of course, you want to add a few options.
Windows?
A CD-ROM drive, need that.
What the fuck? It's no, get that out of here.
Sound card, need that. Ugh. Memory management and adapter.
Oh, what
of course
the
you
fuck?
Wanna memorize some commands. You need some instructional books for that.
Yeah, you need all this shit.
Fletcher was.
You need all this. You need a graphics card, and you need a sound card. You need a monitor and everything. And look at how much that is. And let's come over to the Apple computer, which is twice as expensive as what I just showed you.
He's making a point.
Oh, and also you have to configure this one to run multimedia. Mr. M, now all of this is yours for a mere.
Uh-oh. Pop was not impressed. But then...
On the other hand...
Not in the 90s.
You could buy a Macintosh Performa.
Yeah. Huh. Fletcher showed us the Performa. It was like the Macintoshes we had at school. Except it came with a whole bunch of extras. It had CD-ROMs that Zoe and I could use for learning. There are programs Mom could use for home business.
Whoa, look at all these financial
modem,
charts.
Too, to get information online. Plus, there were games. This was a lot
is Grandpa the gamer?
PC with Windows. Games. Mine. Plus.
Grandpa's the gamer.
There were games. This was a lot easier than a PC with Windows, and Fletcher showed us why. On the Windows PC, he had to know pathways and commands to manage files.
No,
but
you
with
didn't.
The Performa,
how
you
long?
Just clicked
Wait.
On a file, and there you were.
Was this the
on
the DOS
Windows
kind
PC,
of heyday?
Running a CD-ROM was a real hassle.
I guess this was with yeah DOS.
With the
you're
Performa,
right.
You just put in the disk, and bam, it made everything you want to do simple.
Oh, show me about birds
sure
of
Pop
prey.
Was gonna buy the Performa.
And the price.
All right, everybody
was
thinks.
Buy the Performa.
All right, some of you guys might think that like, oh, that's kind of a random thing. I have sat there on YouTube. And just kind of had my chin down like this with like my iPad here. And I probably have typed in to just like, what was Harry Truman's life like? Show me an eagle in a nest. You know, like I feel like I do that all the time. I just look up random shit.
We all thought for sure Pop was gonna buy the Performa.
And the price?
It was a done deal.
How much?
Think about it, all right?
Think about it? No way.
How much
What's
was it?
To think about? We saw that one work. We saw this one work. This is better.
Now here's where the You're fun the began.
What expert?
Because Gramps and Pop, they always see things different.
Oh, no, they're arguing in the store.
What, me?
Pop went one way.
I'm not going to argue.
Gramps
you, okay?
The other.
I'll buy it, all right?
Yes.
And I'll also pay for the printer.
Gramps.
But and the printer? The
If the family proves that they really need it, then you gotta pay me back.
Oh, Dad.
So that's how it started.
A little friendly wager. What do you say?
Gramps was gonna buy it and bet Pop that we could change his mind about computers.
You're on. I'm on. Okay.
Okay, you got it.
And that's when Pop thought of points.
Okay, kids. Everybody.
Points?
We get 100 points in 1 month, and I'll pay for the computer.
How do we get points?
I'll figure it out.
You.
All I knew was that we were
scammed by Grandpa.
Home.
No, not you.
And the next month was going to be very interesting.
Grandpa just goes in and grabs him like right here. And they go into the back and into the computers.
If you're thinking about a home computer,
it's important to make the right choice. That means a computer that's ready for tomorrow, with exciting technologies like multimedia. The Macintosh Performa is way ahead of other computers because its multimedia really works easily. Want video?
Yes.
It's as simple as plugging in a VCR or a camcorder.
Wow.
With the Performa,
that's actually pretty,
you can
that's a pretty big deal.
And edit your own video production.
That's a pretty big deal.
Right on your computer. And with an Apple Color printer, you can even put your video pictures into family newsletters or greeting cards.
All right, here, I know. You guys have to understand, though, we are so spoiled by how the world is right now with, like, information technology, right? But the act of printing a picture, like a color picture, was, like, insanity. It'd never been able to happen before. So, I mean, it might seem stupid now to be like, and by the way, there's a color printer. It's like, what? Oh my goodness. How? Like an inkjet?
CD-ROMs.
No way.
Nothing beats.
That was like going from black and white to color.
It's a performer. You see, many computers with Windows have to be reconfigured or restarted over and over
typing.
Again to run many CD-ROMs. But with a Macintosh, a simple click is all it takes. This Performa also includes a fantastic new technology that fills your screen with
MPEG.
Full motion TV quality images. Images that set a whole new standard for visual quality. If you want true multimedia, get the computer that does it best and makes it easy. The PowerPC driven Macintosh Performa.
Quality.
Apple has a full line of Performa computers. And to find the one that's right for you, just call this number now. Apple will send you a free information kit that includes all you need to know.
Okay, I just thought, I thought something just popped up on my screen. I was like, why?
Make the perfect choice. You'll discover the Performa 5215.
2300. Look at these specs. 8 megabytes of RAM. 1 gigabyte hard drive. That's actually kind of, that's a lot. 75 megahertz PowerPC 603. Times 4 CD-ROM drive. Speakerphone and answering machine comes with it too.
A popular all-in-one computer that's great for families. For a modular design,
a gigabyte hard drive, that's a lot.
6200 CD.
Then.
As your needs grow,
that's a lot.
It will too. There are other Performa models to choose as well, and each comes with over $1,300 worth.
1995 Grolier Multimedia Encyclopedia. Encyclopedia CDs were huge back
then. The software at no extra charge. This is a tremendous offer you can't afford to miss, but the time to act is right now. Call this number now for your free product.
All right, so how did the family turn out? Do we get to see the end of that, or is that a cliffhanger? Is there part 3? I have part 2 here. Where's part 3? Oh, there we go. There's part 3. There's a part. There's so many parts.
Drop in the title and copy it to the VCR.
There's so many parts.
Physical projections for Hong Kong.
Great work.
All right, let's.
Who did you hire to put this together?
I did it in house.
It's 6 parts. All right, we're just gonna skip to the family bits. Oh, here we go. They got it.
Computer home was a pretty big deal in our family, and we couldn't wait to set it up.
There it is.
Pop read all the instructions, but we kids knew it was simple.
Keyboard. Mouse.
Yep.
Printer.
Ooh, it's only 3 plugs. That's it.
It didn't take a rocket
Easy.
Scientist. But Pop took no chances.
According to this, the procedure.
What about the cable management?
Hey, Pop. You want the honors? Now came the moment of truth.
The cable management's fucking dog shit here.
Would it actually work? The suspense was too much until. Welcome to Macintosh.
Hey.
Welcome to the Martinettis.
Even the dog likes it.
The Performa had a demo that made learning to use it easy.
Okay, what do I do now?
Click here, Mom.
And right from the start.
What do I do now?
Uh-huh.
You imagine being presented.
Okay, what do I do now?
Being presented with this for the first time. Okay, back in like the like 1800s, if you were to film like a train coming towards the camera, the people in the audience would run out of the theater thinking the train was going to hit them. This is a very, very, this is a very collected response to this kind of, you know, technology. This is the first time you're seeing this. All right, what do I do now? Like, yeah, that's very collected. I would be freaking out.
Click here, Mom.
And right from the start, everybody could.
Clarus work.
Uh-huh. Best of all, the computer came with all kinds of programs ready to use. There are programs for writing and drawing. Programs for managing with a 3D atlas that was...
Wait, is that like diagnosing?
It came with a 3D atlas that was...
Wait, hold on.
It had a full encyclopedia with pictures and sound. The family doctor, and it came with...
Huh? Wait. The Family Doctor 3rd Edition. Is this like WebMD?
The 3D...
So you could go and type...
Atlas, that's... that was so cool, you could believe you were anywhere on the planet.
This is so interesting, it
now,
really is.
No, it didn't take long to get the hang of things, and Mom proved it. She put together the first ever Martinetti family newsletter. She took pictures we had from videos...
Extra!
And made those part of it, too. And when she printed it out, I could almost sense a new career in the making. Mom, yeah. Media mogul. Hey,
somebody, didn't somebody say the Martinetti Cinematic Universe?
Back to Earth.
All right, from UV. Now, exactly. Remember our deal. Earn 100 points, and I pay for the computer.
Dad, the thing's fucking phenomenal. It's a remarkable, new, ridiculous piece of technology. You lost. I mean, come on. Just pay Grandpa. It's like, really?
Otherwise...
How do we get points?
Well, here's what I've worked out. You do your homework on the computer, you get a point. You raise your grade, you get 2 points.
No. Come on. That's worth at least 10.
Yeah, Grandpa, come on.
All right.
I have to hand it to Pop.
5 points.
He never makes a decision lightly.
If I use it for business?
Yeah.
If you told him this computer could take him to the moon, he'd want to go 3 times.
Well, no. You know, the reason why Grandpa's not into this is because... This kid's got, like, fucking D's. And he is now has to rely on this kid to make it so he doesn't have to pay, like, $2,500 for a computer. So it's like, hold on now, let's not tie it to grades. How about, let's tie it to, times that they do the dishes. Is that better? That sounds better. That's a good idea.
If you told him this computer could take him to the moon, he'd want to go 3 times to make sure.
It's just an important purchase, Mayor. I want to make sure everybody uses it.
What did I tell you? The funny thing was, the computer fit into our family just like it belonged.
$2,590
bucks. It really helped us all in different ways.
What is that now?
Mom found she could do her whole greeting card business
grand?
With it. She could design new cards and make changes just like that.
Like 5K? 6K?
And to send a copy to her publisher, she just faxed it right from the performa.
Open wide and say,
we played this game. We actually played that exact game. That's Dinosaur
Zoe had
Adventure.
A whole other universe to explore. She loved learning with multimedia and couldn't get enough.
Arthur's teacher trouble.
She could read stories that came to life.
That week, everyone in Arthur's class studied harder than ever.
And that taught her things about the world.
Bro, what the fuck happened?
Fletcher, it's...
We went from this to, like, Elsa beats Spider-Man up with a baseball bat. What the fuck happened? What the hell happened?
Said there were thousands of CD-ROMs out there. I believed it. And Zoe would have had them all if she could. For me, I like that our computer's a Mac.
Algorithms.
Because that's what our school has. And the Macs at school have tons of stuff I use. Only now, instead of staying late, I could bring my work home.
Floppy disk?
I could use our computer.
Aye, those are so cool. I like the sound those made.
I could make reports with pictures and sound that were just fantastic.
When you punched that in the machine, it did this like... It was awesome.
I think it was Gramps, though, who did the most amazing things. He figured out all kinds of stuff to do with the computer.
Great sub sound, Grandpa.
And he discovered eWorld, the online service from Apple.
eWorld?
Gramps had never seen an online service, but before you knew it, he was meeting people from all over.
Well, Grandpa's meeting people?
I think it did him a lot of good. More good than he ever dreamed.
You know, Frank, there's other people out there just like me.
No.
Really? People like the same things
there's
I do.
There's other towns, there's other cities.
So who's Rose?
There's other...
Never you mind.
Wait,
what? As the
weeks
went by, we kept burning points.
Grandpa's on Reddit.
Okay, now, including homework, mom's work, Grandpa's stuff, there's 72 points here.
They're so close.
Not bad.
Of course, Zoe thought she deserved points for beating Pop in games.
No points for games.
And Gramps agreed.
Hey, why not? You learn things from games.
Exactly.
Frank and I Empire thought so. But Pop didn't exactly see
well,
it our way.
Somebody's not learning enough.
TJ, we'll get points if you bring your math grade up.
I know, I'm working on
you got
it.
Got a D.
The proof's in the pudding.
That's why Grandpa
Pop,
was
you know
so. Didn't want to do that.
The proof.
I hate it.
Is a in the pudding. I like it.
Okay, everybody. Family picture. Perfect.
Oh, this
the
is where
was,
the
we were having the time of our
full circle. Here we
computer.
Are.
And there was no turning back. We just had to convince Pop to keep it. We were desperate. And desperate people try anything. Even math programs.
Was he eating out of the dog bowl?
People try anything. Even math
what
programs.
What is that? Of Rose. I've heard several of her performances and think she's simply the best. Tomorrow I'll send you a list of some of her best performances. Regards, Carmine.
Okay. What's this?
Never mind. I'll be off here in a minute so you can do your math.
I
Grandpa,
never
what are all those tabs?
Machine can make right so now. Much difference.
No, those are nothing. Those are absolutely nothing. Nothing.
For a family. And you know what? I still didn't know the half of it. Like, who's Rose?
Who's Rose?
One of the best gifts you can give to any child is a love of learning. And there's no better way to do that than with a Macintosh computer and a world of learning programs.
Hi, folks. I'm evil uncle, Greg Martinelli. I'm gonna come in and fuck the whole thing up later in the show. Skip, stop skipping. We've seen this already.
This is our house.
This is my room. This is our kitchen.
Not the
this is my
Eddie.
Homework. This is due tomorrow.
This is where I plug in my guitar.
This is where you plug in the printer.
This is a lawnmower I'm fixing.
This is a proposal.
I thought he was plugging the lawnmower into the computer. Like, dude, that's not, you got that, you got wrong info, man.
Fixing.
Ties.
Checks.
Paints.
Faxes.
This is my encyclopedia.
Our taxes.
Astronauts. Dinosaurs.
Socks.
It's always dinosaurs. Have you noticed that?
This is our Mac.
It's easy.
You guys notice that all old multimedia, all old software apparently has to be dinosaur related? It's just, it has to be related to a dinosaur.
In the days that followed, we all worked on the new computer. Mom did business. Zoe learned all about animals and music. I practiced my equations.
And nobody played with the dog.
And Gramps, he made friends all over cyberspace. Frank went back to college, but he kept in touch with email from the Mac in his dorm. Using the computer just became second nature at our house.
Pop, send money. What?
This is really helping?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, you can do your business better now?
Absolutely. Come here, I'll show you what I've been working on. Do you like this one?
Very nice.
Good. I'm faxing a draft to the publisher.
How?
The computer had programs that could help Mom do everything. She could keep track of work schedules, addresses,
and projects. It's a cyber scam?
All right here.
These are your orders?
Uh-huh.
Not bad.
Zoe, now there's another story. What she did on the computer was awesome. She had a video that we shot at the zoo, and she took scenes from it to make her own picture book.
That's cool.
We went to the zoo, TJ and me. You wouldn't believe all the animals we'd see. Do you like it, Pop?
Dad's gonna get addicted to the league.
I think it's gonna be a bestseller.
Oh, here comes Tamino. Oh. He's the hero. He's the guy that gets the magic flute.
Now, Gramps, he loves to talk opera. Mm-hmm. With the CD-ROMs he had, he could talk it with us, and we could learn.
Being chased by a serpent.
What happens after that? Gramps took to the computer like an old hand.
Listen.
Wait, is this a choose-your-own-adventure book?
You know,
he has his own music.
I had a feeling there's something different about him now. Like he had a secret he wasn't ready to share.
Every time you see the serpent, you'll hear that same music. So you can tell the serpent.
As for me, I worked on my favorite subject. Well, math wasn't so bad. If you could go at your own pace.
Yeah, what was the anti-feminism thing? What? Was that what that said? Wait. What's happening?
And with the computer, I could.
I think you've got it.
It was about this time that Pop got it, too. I mean, liking the computer. I remember one night, I was awake late.
Oh, he's gonna catch Dad.
There was Pop. I couldn't believe it. He was calling up eWorld to get quotes on stocks. And he found news articles he wanted, too.
That's what he told me. Why would Dad lie to me?
Budgets and investments.
Yeah, investments.
He could even use his DOS files from the office right on the Mac.
And MS-DOS.
Stocks. I know you're there, TJ.
Have you ever used this thing before?
The last few nights.
Are those milk and cookies? What, is Dad Santa?
Can I pop?
Wait, I don't...
And then came the day of reckoning.
Email from Frank. He's coming home this weekend.
I got a new order today. A happy Mother's Day card.
Yay! That's a point for us.
Yes.
Oh, that's another point.
You guys will never believe this. Guess what?
What?
I got a B+.
TJ, a B.
B+.
He did it.
That's
terrific,
great.
Pal. You did great. Woo. We're just a couple of more points to go.
You didn't add mine, Dad.
Why, you got points?
What for?
Oh, I used the computer to balance the budget, analyze our finances. I made some big decisions on it. Put me down for 5.
5?
What? Yes. Even Dad is there doing it. And now Dad added points, and the computer now is, he has to pay for it.
We did it.
We're keeping the computer.
No, I'm in the wrong
I
house.
Love this, Grandpa.
You were never gonna let the computer go, were you?
But...
No.
Are we realizing right now that Grandpa's the only one that can hear the music?
What's happening?
Frank, we're keeping the computer.
No, I'm in the wrong house.
Can they all hear?
You were never gonna let the computer go, were you?
I just wanted to make sure everybody would use it.
Can they all hear it?
You know, I guess I better write that check, huh?
Oh, I'll get it!
Who is it? It's Grandma!
Is Carmine in?
Grandpa?
It's Rose.
You must be Rose.
And you must be Carmine. Am I late?
Oh, no, you're right on time. Hey, everybody, this is Rose.
Well,
hey, Rose.
TJ.
Welcome.
Zoe.
Where'd you two meet?
Right over here on the Opera Lovers Forum.
The Opera Lovers Forum! So that's what Gramps had been doing all this time.
So this is your performa?
Yep, that's it.
Oh, it's
How
a
many
real...
How of RAM, Carmine?
It's a real piece of shit,
Eight.
Carmine.
I knew you were a power user.
Yeah. You know what? I read all the magazines.
I do too.
Oh, but can it run Crisis? Mine can.
Come back, and it's like... Everything changes.
There's more.
I'd like to propose a toast.
To our honored guest, Rose, you are always welcome in our home.
Salute.
Salute, Dad.
Salute, Rose.
So that's our story. 1 month in the life of the Martinettis. I wouldn't say that everything that happened was on account of our computer, but I wouldn't say it wasn't either. I mean, we didn't only get a computer, it got us.
Power user.
And sometimes I think it even knows what it got itself into. Well, after all, it is a Macintosh.
Here he is.
One of the great things about, Macintosh.
How did that make you feel? If you were to write down your thoughts on that last commercial, what would you write?
Forma is the way it helps you keep in touch with the world. From cruising the internet to sending email, a performer can take you everywhere you want to.
All right, that was fun. Any more?
This is a tremendous offering.
Family room?
The marketing department.
This is the conference room.
These are not the Martinettis. We almost missed the fucking dog post-credits scene. Is he pissed on the computer? Okay. That's it. That was a blog? Okay, that was the Martinetti's take home a computer. All right, we got some more food ones, but all right, should I do some more food ones? Yeah, absolutely. How about the grill disc? Grill disc.
Everyone loves that real outdoor barbecue flavor, but when you don't have the space, you miss out on the taste. Not anymore. Hi, I'm Joe Fowler, and this is the nonstick grill disc that turns virtually any pan into an indoor grill.
You what?
Just place, heat, and eat. You'll hear the sear and see the grill marks locking in that delicious outdoor flavor.
So, okay, wait. Let me ask a question. Everybody here. This doesn't do anything, right? This is just a way to make a aesthetically pleasing image on your food. This doesn't, like, do anything different. You're still cooking. It's not anything different, right? No. Am I wrong? Does it actually do anything different?
And the taste?
Isn't it just like, if you just...
So good!
But if you just cooked it in...
The disc is made from high heat steel.
But if you cook it...
The cooking surface of a real grill...
What?
Inside your pan. And unlike flame flare-ups that can ruin your food, grill disc distributes the heat evenly to the entire disc.
Does it
so
do anything?
So the food is always perfectly cooked. Grill disc makes the world's best hamburgers. Cook juicy pork chops to grill perfection.
It's kind of this slide around.
Fillets, they'll come running for. And now when it rains or snows, you've got the grill that will never close. And I want you to see this. Because the disc is raised, it creates a flavor channel for your favorite marinade. Just add the lid and seal the flavors right in.
That's cool.
The disc is super non-stick, so you can grill up that delicate fish without the worry. We've all seen foods that fall through the grill, but with Grill Disc, they never will. Make delicious shrimp on a barbie, tasty sausage and peppers, or grill veggies and fruit to perfection.
Wow.
And here's a family favorite, Mexican.
Watch out for that hot pan. Watch out for that hot pan. That's too close. That's a hot pan, man. Don't just bring it over to the table.
The best grilled cheese sandwiches. Grill up pound cake for a delicious dessert. Plus, clean up some breeze. You can call or go online now.
All right, I mean, this is...
Grill disc.
All right, the grill disc.
Grilling guide for the special...
All right, whatever. All right, fine. The grill disc is not... Whatever. That's fine. What about the flavor stone? Pound cake? Yeah, what? Yeah, that's weird. A pound cake on the grill? I was just not even paying attention. I honestly blanked on that one. Yeah, that was a grilling a pound cake. It's kind of fucking weird. All right. We're gonna do, I got a lot of tabs up here. How about, Culinary Rocket Chef?
The program you are watching is a paid advertisement for Rocket Chef, presented by Culinaire.
Don't touch that remote. During the next few minutes, we'll tell you about a $40 million giveaway promotion. You can get a fabulous Rocket Chef for a friend.
What the fuck?
During the next few minutes.
No way. No. There's no fucking way. Oh, stay tuned. We've got buy one, get one free. Oh, stay tuned on a fantastic deal for the Rocket Chef. Stay tuned for the $40 million giveaway. Don't go anywhere. You could be rich soon. What?
We'll tell you about a $40 million giveaway promotion.
What the fuck?
You can get a fabulous rocket ship for a friend absolutely free. And for yourself, you'll get the amazing fat-free gourmet.
We can't go anywhere.
A $40 value also free. This cooking
we're not going anywhere. I need to know about the $40 million giveaway.
With fewer calories, less cholesterol, but lots
insane.
Of flavor. Watch how you can get it free as we introduce Rocket Chef, a modern marvel that...
Dude, this company, I don't think even had $40 million in... Like, liquid capital. What are they... I need to know what they're talking about. I have to fucking know. We need to know.
Replaces all these bulky machines. Wouldn't it be great if one appliance could cut better than a knife, slice faster than a slicer, chop better than a food processor, blend better than a blender,
yeah.
And do it all in a fraction of
yeah,
the time?
Yeah, of course.
Rocket Chef can, and it goes from the freezer to the microwave to the table. Plus, okay. It does your food preparation so easily. Yes, that one appliance is here. Stay tuned to learn how, during this one-of-a-kind $40 million giveaway promotion, you can get an extra one of these amazing appliances absolutely free.
And $40 million. Oh, stay tuned to find out how you can get not one but two Rocket Chefs and $40 million for free. Holy shit.
Plus a calorie-saving, fat-free gourmet.
I'm
as
shocked.
An additional free bowl.
You
also get the fantastic magic can. Absolutely free. It's the only can opener which opens from the side of the can, so the
what?
Lid stays smooth and safe, and it's yours free. Ladies and gentlemen, Nancy Nelson.
Welcome to the Culinary Kitchen. I am Nancy Nelson. And today, together, we're going to discover a whole new way to make life easier,
yeah.
Simpler, and a lot more fun in the
great.
Kitchen. This is why it's called the Rocket Chef.
I'm sure
but
it's a good product.
I have to admit, I'm not the expert on Rocket Chef. The guy who is someone who's very familiar to you, the famous man with the red bow tie, a friend of yours, certainly of mine, John
billionaire
Marcus.
John Marcus.
Hi. Great to see you.
Rocket Chef, and as I'm standing here looking at this gorgeous food, this has all been created by Rocket Chef?
This is not just gorgeous food. This was made by the Rocket Chef. It's fresh, nutritious, healthy meals, rocket fuel, rocket fast for your family, Nancy.
Cookie dough. The dough in here, which is so
really,
hard.
Really fast.
Why did it just get quiet?
We keep saying fast, and, obviously.
Oh, sorry. We had to cut off the part where they're giving away the $40 million. I can't even hear it.
Let me try and explain it this way. If you're going to slice or chop an onion, you probably use one of these, right?
Sure.
A knife.
Right.
A single blade.
Yeah.
No matter how quick you chop or slice, it's still only one stroke at a time.
Yes.
You with me up to now?
Up to now.
Simple. Okay. Now then, what do you see? Two blades.
Two blades. Okay. Twice as fast.
Oh,
of
Nancy,
course.
Hold
that's
that
why.
Thought.
Is it? All right. I think is it, there's got to be another version of this, right? 24 minutes? 25 minutes? Is this the same one? This is the same one. I think this is, yeah. No, I think this is the same one. 22 minutes?
Cookie dough.
And you can make the dough.
Shit, it's all fucked up. There's no, it doesn't exist.
Wait, and fast. We keep
I can't
fast,
turn it up. It's as loud as it goes.
Why does it work so fast, John?
Let me try and explain it this way. If you're going to slice or chop an onion, you probably use one of these, right?
Sure.
A knife.
Right.
A single blade.
Yeah.
No matter how quick you chop or slice,
sorry.
It's still only one stroke at a time.
Yes.
You with me up to now?
Up to now.
Simple. Okay. Now then, what do you see? Two blades.
Two blades. Okay. Twice.
Two blades.
Yeah.
Oh,
of
Nancy,
course. That's
hold
why.
That thought. Because when you turn the handle one full turn, those two
she
blades.
Get that away from her
turn
face.
Four times. Two times four, Nancy.
Eight.
So it's like slicing and chopping with eight knives or blades at the same time.
Holy John Harkin.
Rocket fast. Nancy, let's say you want to do something like salsa. Put some herbs in. We'll take some onions, some whole
tomatoes. She's going to take a whole step
you're putting
this way.
Hole, John. You're well, not.
Nancy, I told you. It really is rocket fast. Now, remember,
so it's a food processor.
Really fresh because you made it
when you needed it. Nancy, you want to try some?
That took you a few seconds
it's that
to do.
Quick. It's that
a
quick
few
Nancy.
Seconds. Try oh my gosh. Oh, you
so it's just like a salsa?
This is so good.
But you know what,
it's
Nancy?
Fresh.
Nancy,
what?
Let's say you didn't want to make salsa.
Okay.
What? This, that was four sauces.
Sauce. All you do is you chop up the ingredients, add some molasses and some chili powder. Why don't you do that, Nancy? I'm
going to
do something different.
Into the salsa?
Put the chili powder in here.
Right. Turn the handle. You ready?
Oh, I like
you put it in the salsa.
I don't have to take the top off. I can pour it in.
What?
See, that saves straight time, too. All
come
right?
On. Are you ready? Let's go. And you know what, Nancy? The beauty
is,
you know what went in, so you know what
why
comes
is it
out.
So easy? I
mean,
like doing
do you know
this.
Why these things from the store? You know, who knows, what's inside these things? But Nancy, take a look
take
at mine.
Take this off.
And look at that.
Don't read the ingredient label. It's lies.
Barbecue sauce.
In so
barbecue sauce?
Take a look at mine.
I'm lost. Wait a minute.
Oh,
everybody hold on.
You're putting them in.
I want to do something like salsa. Put some herbs in. We'll take some onions.
He's made a salsa.
You are,
and then he just put molasses in it, and it's a barbecue sauce.
You're putting,
see, take a look
take
at mine.
Off.
Who are going to put this and run?
And
that's what happened.
Nancy, take a look at mine, because you know what I made? Look at what I made. Fresh, delicious gazpacho, done in seconds. But you know what? Oh, Nancy, I got to tell you. What's the one job we all hate?
With those things back there, cleanup is complicated.
Nancy, the cleanup, you rinse and run.
That's so it?
Now, how about some
what about baked on cheese?
Healthy low-fat mayonnaise.
Oh, homemade, that's wonderful.
And you know why we need it? Because now we're in John's Deli.
Oh.
Here we've got three ladies from the studio audience who are going to put the rocket chef against the rocket clock. Now then, on the count of three ladies...
Making a sandwich? A deli sandwich?
And they're going to prepare, family favorites. All
this
the
not like
rolls, so we're gonna save a
deli
lot of
chicken,
time.
Deli cheese, and mayonnaise in there, right?
Under 10 seconds.
Yeah, I can't believe how fast I went. Joyce, you have three teenagers at home. You made gorgeous tuna salad. How's the rocket chef going to work for them?
Oh, this is great because they can prepare
okay.
it themselves. They can clean it up themselves, which, of course, gives me more time.
Good plan,
great.
Mom. Tamar, oh,
what did you make?
Just looking egg salad. You have a little three-year-old who likes to help mommy.
Yes, loves to chop things. The blade's on the inside. It's safe. It's easy. She can even spin it and help clean up.
What a
right.
good idea.
They move, all right, they move over to this lady, and she's just like, she didn't do anything. It's just all the ingredients are still in there, and she's just like, I didn't understand the instructions. So they just like move on. Oh, okay, yeah, sure, whatever.
What's this? Ooh, chicken salad. Now, you're single, so often waste is a problem.
What is that?
Right, I always make too much, but this I can use just the right portion.
Oh, but you know what? If you make a small batch or a large batch, it makes no difference. There's no waste, because with this seal and save lid... Come
what was in there?
Nancy, run to the fridge, get the door.
Yes,
waste ain't going to be a problem anymore, Nancy. Just pop it in, and your leftovers are taken care of. Don't forget, rocket meals, rocket fast, with the Rocket Chef. Now, then, what about the all-American favorite... meatloaf. You simply pop all the ingredients into one bowl.
Yeah.
That's going to save you a lot of
it's
time.
It's making
right?
meatloaf.
You can make your meatloaf in your rocket ship.
Mouth-watering meatloaf, but of course it wouldn't be complete
beautiful.
Without mashed potatoes. Now, Nancy, you can add milk.
Okay, so it can make
milk,
sludge.
I'd like to add some roasted garlic. Oh, and you can have
oh.
delicious
right, like,
creamy
if you're,
potatoes.
If it's a sludge-based food, then it'll be fine. It does it.
It certainly is.
Is it mayo-based? Is it a sauce? All right.
Get to that in a second, okay? Let's not forget what the rocket
don't open those.
You've seen it slice, chop, beat, blend, mix, whip, whisk, shred, and grate. In fact, virtually replace a whole kitchen full of appliances.
Yes.
That could cost you hundreds and hundreds of dollars, Nancy.
No question.
Even, potentially even $40 million, John.
I'd love to have one, wouldn't you? Yes. All right. How
okay,
we get the
well, this
chef?
Is what you get. Now you get the rocket bowl. And the rocket bowl you can use in the microwave and it's dishwasher safe.
Yes.
You also get all the blades and attachments, which mean you can virtually replace a whole kitchen full of appliances. Now you get the rocket dome with the patented gravity speed feeder.
The rocket
and, of course, the
dough?
Two-gear ratio, so you can work at the power of eight blades. Nancy, we also give you the seal and store lid so you can put it on
and
the top.
And the refrigerator
so
and the
waste,
microwave
of course,
and all that
gonna
time.
That's going to save you money. But you know what, Nancy? We're also going to give you some great low-fat, healthy recipes with the recipe guide. Nancy, you could spend hundreds and hundreds of dollars to try and buy appliances that can do what...
This guy's doing TikTok shit. Imagine this guy, but framed with just like this, and it's a TikTok video.
Nancy, we're also going to give you some great low-fat, healthy recipes with the recipe guide. Nancy, you could spend hundreds and hundreds of dollars to try and buy appliances that can do what the Rocket Chef does. But
like,
I got to tell you,
he's like doing the animated thing.
Hundreds of dollars. We're not even going to charge you a single.
That's TikTok right there, especially right here, right here.
Charge you a single
Not even going to charge you. Not even going to charge you a single $100.
This guy was killing it.
Nancy, less than half that.
Wow.
Just two easy payments of $19.95.
Okay. No, fuck that. You put her, edit her in there holding up a phone like this, holding a phone up facing him, and I'm telling you right now, this is a TikToker. She's going like this right there.
To replace a whole kitchen full of appliances. Now you get the rocket dome with the patented gravity speed feeder and, of course, the two-gear ratio so you can work in the power of eight blades. Nancy, you know, we also give you the seal and store lid so you can put it on
and
the top.
And the refrigerator and the microwave and
course,
all that time.
Of course, that's going to save you money. But you know what, Nancy? We're also going to give you some great low-fat, healthy recipes with the recipe guide. Nancy, you know, you could spend hundreds and hundreds of dollars to try and buy appliances that can do what the Rocket Chef does. But I got to tell you, we're not going to charge... payments of $19.95.
Oh, that's a great value. Don't you think that's wonderful?
Isn't it wonderful?
It really
now
is.
It's time to take the peek. Lift the lids.
Oh, we get to see what's in here. You want to see you guys? All right.
What do you think, Nancy?
Oh, is that beautiful?
Oh, isn't it just... Now, remember what I said. You could replace virtually a kitchen full of appliances.
Yes.
And no kitchen would be complete without an...
I only did that for like the 10 of you that thought that was funny. And I know, and you and I get it. We get it. You know what I mean? Like this. There's tens of thousands of people here, and they're all like, "This guy fucking that joke was terrible." But for like the 50 of you, you know what I mean? Like you and I, we get it. You know, we get it.
Ice cream maker. I mean, that one over there cost almost twice the price of the Rocket Chef system, and it isn't going to do everything that this can do.
Wait. Are you going to tell us that the Rocket Chef is going to make ice cream and
Nancy,
sherbet?
Nancy, your kids are going to love this. Your family, I'll
the
tell
10
you.
Of us don't use TikTok.
We're just going to show you how to make sorbets and sherbets and healthy ice cream. We're also going to give you a fabulous Rocket Chef blade, which will allow you to make all of these
recipes.
It's
a special blade
for
making ice
blade.
Cream.
We've
all
also
right.
got a fabulous Rocket Chef scoop. Now, this we're going to include.
I hated that. Did you hate that because you don't like the song, or did you hate that because you didn't like the routine that just happened?
System for the low, low price, just two easy payments of $19.95.
This is wonderful, John. Thank you. It's a great
Nancy,
value.
Nancy, you're welcome. Did I say I was finished?
You know, I thought about it. I was sitting there going like, should I do like the oh no thing? Like I couldn't. I'm gonna lose 5,000 people. But I had to do it. I had to. There's nothing that was gonna stop me.
Over here, please.
Nothing was gonna stop me.
Ever quit?
Hold the bowl. Has this ever happened to you? You've been at home, you're in a hurry, lots of hassles, you're trying to make salad for
Jesus,
the family.
Jesus, man, stop.
Face, you can miss the
bowl. Watch out for the knife. Yes.
Well,
now, be careful.
To us all. Well, look at this, because this is the Rocket Chef chopping board.
Oh, isn't that nice?
But watch, Nancy, when you take hold of the handle, it folds. So from now on, every single time, you're going to hit the spot.
Yeah. All right, that's cool.
Great idea. Nancy.
All right.
Nancy. This on its own is a $20 value.
All right,
on
that was cool.
On this occasion, we're going to include it at no extra cost. That's the complete Rocket Chef system for two easy payments of $19.95.
That's great, isn't it? What do you think? Would you like to have the Rocket Chef at all?
That's $40. What? That's, you know, $40.
Make sure you come back because we still have had people standing by at the mall ready to challenge some professional chefs.
Professional chefs. Okay.
We have ice cream, we have more rocket meals, we have John Parkin. You pick okay. up the phone and get a Rocket Chef for yourself.
Oh, yep, yep, yep.
I live in a very small apartment, so number one, it's space.
Save him a lot of money with this product.
By changing the attachments.
Where's the $40 million?
Did exactly what I needed it to do. I live in a very small apartment, so number one, it's space saving.
Clean up the stench.
What if they just don't go anywhere with that?
Done.
What if that was just made up?
Ever since the beginning of time, mankind has been searching for ways to make life easier in the kitchen.
Onion?
From the Stone Age to the Machine Age, our kitchens have become cluttered with expensive kitchen machines that just take up space.
What is going on? Why are they all so fucked up? What? why are they so, like, disheveled?
Age to the machine age, our kitchens have become...
What is going on here? Are they clearing out their cabinets?
Fluttered with...
Why is everything so dusty, and why are they all so beat up looking? The meth lab.
That just take up space and collect.
It's an illegal meth drug den.
Dust. Well, now the art of cooking blasts off into the space age with Rocket Chef.
So
Rocket Chef is like having a kitchen full of appliances combined into one, and it's so easy to use. Just insert.
Imagine using the Rocket Chef.
Lid and you're ready. Watch as we make tasty homemade salsa rocket fast. Want a slice? Just snap in the thick or thin cassette blade, and it becomes a supersonic speed slicer.
And a caveman?
And Rocket Chef speed feeder. This cucumber is sliced to precise perfection every time.
All right, $40 million. I'm sorry. Where is that?
It peels it for you. Not even the most expensive food processor does that. And you can cut up whole onions with no more tears because the odor stays inside your Rocket Chef. But it doesn't stop there. Snap in the grating attachment and it becomes a great grater.
Okay.
Or insert the Space Age whipping blade and it's as powerful as a professional mixer.
No, it's not.
Rocket Chef is even stronger.
No, it is not.
Into delicious
no, it's
drinks.
Not. Spinning a blade like this is not as powerful. No, it is not. Lie.
Speed gives
come on,
power
man.
And precision to
thing's cool and it probably works, but more than a professional whipping machine.
Handle, the blades turn four times. Giving you the power of eight knives. You'll make delicious.
Watch as we put blood in the Rocket Chef and we separate the plasma and the white blood cells from the red blood cells as a centrifuge.
Made meals and snacks rocket fast and rocket easy. Make meatloaf your way in one bowl in a minute. Healthy homemade soups in seconds and heat them up in the microwave because the Rocket Chef bowl is microwave safe. How about fresh tuna, chicken, or egg salad in just seconds? Making lunch just became a lot easier.
And that's an application I would use this for. I just would. That's a pain in the ass.
Foods fresh.
Making
Rocket
tuna,
is so compact, it's great for campers,
it's kind of messy. It, you know, it smells,
forget, all,
right? Like, that's a pain
just
in the ass. That's the one reason why I would use this.
The complete Rocket Chef system includes the microwave-safe base, the two-speed rocket dome with speed feeder, the patented cassette system with thick and thin slicing blade.
What did he say?
Chopper,
wait, what did you say, Peter?
Rocket Chef system includes the microwave safe base, the two-speed rocket dome with speed feeder, the patented cassette system with thick and thin slicing blade.
I'm sorry, that's all I heard.
Grating attachment.
That's the only thing I heard.
Blade, the handy snap seal and save lid, and the Rocket Chef fast and easy recipe guide. Rocket Chef replaces well over $500 of bulky and complicated kitchen machines.
Where's the $40 million?
But call now, and the complete Rocket Chef system is yours for just two low payments of $19.95. And it's backed by Culinaire's lifetime, that's right, lifetime warranty. And when you call right now, ask the operator how you can get the Rocket Chef ice cream maker free. To make healthy homemade ice creams, sherbets, and frozen desserts in minutes, an extra $15 value. But it doesn't stop there. Call right now and you'll also receive Culinaire's ingenious cutting board that folds to make kitchen messes
up. There's the $40 million.
Fast. Isn't that clever? And the Culinaire 2-in-1 Chef's Choice Miracle Knife. That's the best slicer and peeler you've ever tried.
All right.
These bonuses add up to an extra $35 value. But when you call right now, they are yours at no extra charge. Try Rocket Chef in your own home for the next 30 days. See for yourself.
We're almost halfway through this, and there's no more mention of the free $40 million giveaway.
Refund of the purchase price, but you can keep the cutting board and 2-in-1 knife as our gift to you just for trying Rocket Chef. Discover what space age cooking is all about. Here's how to get your own Rocket Chef right now. To order Rocket Chef for just two low payments of $19.95, have your credit card ready and call this toll-free number. Or send check or money order for $39.90 plus $7.95 shipping and handling to the address on your screen. Remember, Rocket Chef comes with a lifetime warranty and replaces hundreds of dollars of bulky kitchen appliances.
Where's the $40 million?
10 minutes left to...
It was the other video?
The program...
It certainly is.
This is so exciting now.
What are you doing? Stop. Listen, we'll get to that in a second, okay? Let's not forget what time you're going to hit.
Mankind has been searching for ways to make life easier in seconds and heat them up in the microwave. Right, lifetime warranty.
Right.
When you call right now, ask the operator. Clever. For $35, Sage Cooking is for trying Rocket Chef. Low payments of $19.95, 90 plus 7. Cover what Space Age Cooking is all about.
Right into the Space Age, and boy, has it ever.
Well, thank you, Nancy. But don't forget, it'll not just save you.
God damn, stop! Oh my fucking god! I am so sorry. I did not mean to do that. It's just the whole thing's audio is so fucked up.
fabulous Rocket Chef for a friend absolutely free. And for yourself, you'll get the amazing Fat-Free Gourmet, a $30 value also free. This cooking breakthrough lets you cook food in its own rich flavors and aroma. $1 million. Don't touch that remote. During the next few minutes, we'll tell you about a $40 million giveaway promotion.
What?
Of course, it wouldn't be complete without mashed potato. Extra.
Don't forget, best of all, healthy homemade.
Everything.
Right into the microwave.
Okay, all right.
Oh, Nancy, look at this. Oh, doesn't that smell delicious?
Look at
doesn't that look
oh.
delicious? Nancy, look at that.
That's
oh.
gorgeous.
Oh, wow. The sauce.
But don't forget, with the Rocket Chef, it also grates those hard cheeses.
They always do this, and this is my problem. Ready? Here's my problem with infomercials, and this is a big problem. So they make it, oh, look, it's so easy. Nancy, I've got the sauce. I've got the cheese. I've even got the chicken salad. It's all here in front. You need five of these. You have to grate the cheese, clean the fucking machine, make the sauce in there, clean the machine. They have six of them. There's usually like 6 to 10 of these lined up. Of course, it's going to take you 30 seconds to make a pasta dinner. You've got 10 things on the counter. They should do one where they clean it, and then they do it again.
See, look at that.
Oh, well, over here, we got... This thing's dirty.
But don't forget, with the Rocket Chef, it also grates those hard cheeses. Look at that, Nancy.
You actually did a full Italian meal in a minute.
That's
right.
Yeah, because you have five of them.
You know what? We actually wondered how the Rocket Chef would do in a head-to-head competition between people who are trying it for the very first time and some professional chefs. So why don't we join Discovery Channel's own Maria Clea? She is standing by with...
Okay, this has to go on screen right now. It's very important. It's fucking terrifying. I hate it. I hate this, but it has to go on screen right now. I'm so fucking sorry that was so loud. The audio's all screwed up because of the... You know what I mean? I'm so sorry. I'm just fucking killing you today. Killing me too. Okay. God. Wow. Jesus.
With some very eager volunteers and those
all right.
professional chefs to put
so the here comes the pro chefs
to the test. Hi, Maria. John and Nancy, this is so exciting. We've got three women who are at the mall, and we're going to challenge them with their Rocket Chefs against some professional chefs like Freddy Saucedo. What are you going to be making, Freddy?
Today we're going to be making a guacamole.
All right, Captain, okay. You've got your Rocket Chef. You've got all your ingredients. On the count of three, I want you two to start chopping. One, two, three, go. And here we have...
Anybody else kind of feel like this makes, like, the craft... And, like, the amount of time and, like, care and passion that this guy probably, like, puts into his food and, like... Oh, look, some fucking lady can do it in a machine! It takes her 10 seconds! Doesn't that kind of... I feel like that kind of diminishes what this guy does every day. Doesn't it? Oh, look, this lady came over and she's not like a professional chef.
Mindy,
you idiot.
Making coleslaw against Chef Aaron Lau. Wow, that's some pretty fancy knife work there. Do you use that knife work at the Tokyo Hibachi, Aaron?
Yes, I do.
And why do you think you're going to beat the Rocket Chef?
Well, I got to say.
He's making coleslaw. What? Hold on a minute. They're making these chefs do stuff that only can be made in the Rocket Chef. Oh, professional chef, like doing a crazy, like he's spinning a knife around. You're gonna be chopping up like cabbage and making coleslaw. Oh, you're like an executive chef at this restaurant behind us. Just make like guacamole, like real quick. You make coleslaw.
It's time for the Rocket Chef to go to school.
Oh my! Well, I think you seem pretty confident. So on the count of three, I suggest you two start chopping. One, two. Three,
and it's a lot of chopping.
Down here we have Juliet making some pesto against Emilio Bellissimo of Cafe Bellissimo in Woodland Hills.
I'm going to be making pesto.
Pesto? And how long does it usually take?
Around 40 minutes.
Well, this isn't that long a show now, is it, John? And Nancy, you two on the count of three, start chopping. We'll see how it goes. One, two, three, go.
Maria, Maria,
John.
Don't forget, everything in the same bowl, at the same time, you'll save time, rocket meals, rocket fast.
That's right, you can throw everything in at once. Look at this, Kathy, did you throw everything in? The guacamole, check this out, guys.
And who's is better?
Is often in the
bowl. Oh, you're not even close.
Let's go ahead and have you taste this, Kathy.
No, you know what, no, you get the fuck out of here. Yeah, get out of here, loser.
What do you think?
It's amazing what this little thing can do.
That's right, in fact, why don't you give Freddie a little bite of that? And oh. Coleslaw.
Look
at this. Look how finely chopped.
Very small.
What's up with this?
I'm having one of those days.
You're having one of those
Please, don't.
The pesto, Juliet.
Delicious. Great.
Monster Benny. Emilio, what is happening here?
10 more minutes.
Oh my God. You know what? Rocket fast, rocket chef, rocket speed, rocket fresh. You guys back.
Okay, I'm going to be, let's be real. I got to be real. If I took cabbage in my hands and I just fucking crushed it like this and squished it with my fucking hands and a bowl was underneath and I put mayo in it, just like glug, glug, and then I stirred it up, I don't think anybody would be able to tell the difference. That's like this, not much goes into that really at all. I don't know why they're making it seem like this this master chef. Oh, it's just one of those days, you know, it's just, look at how much better the rocket chef does it. I could do that with my bare hands. It's like carrots. I could literally just break up like carrots in my hands. And cabbage.
Thank you, Maria. Engine's had great.
I mean, it'd be a little chunky, but.
One against the professional chefs.
Three out of three,
yes.
Ain't too bad. But isn't that what it's about, Nancy? I mean, with your kids, for example, you want them to be winners too, don't you?
Sure.
And what a better way to start, you know, than to give them fresh cooked vegetables. I mean, you can do them so quick.
Wait.
With the rocket chef.
Now,
you
those don't are
need... Oh, I thought they were talking about.
You don't
I thought they were talking about giving it to, like, oh, your kids,
yeah.
Not like a baby.
Here's a great idea, Nancy. I know you love dessert.
I love my
what
dessert.
About this, Nancy?
Oh, graham crackers for graham cracker crumbs.
Okay.
Doesn't
so
it already taste
now?
Good?
Listen, apple
okay.
slices, and remember the rocket chef does it rocket fast,
beautiful,
Nancy. How about
slices.
That?
Okay.
And you have your apple pie with graham cracker crust, but I
it has a few specific uses, but it's a food processor, right? It's a food processor that's
you know, we'll get to that in a second.
Easy to clean, whatever.
Okay, we'll be patient, won't we? As a matter of fact, we'll give you time to go to the
All right.
phone and
I think this is the last opportunity we're going to get for the 40 million.
Ice cream. You go ahead and order. We'll wait for you. We'll be right back.
There's only one opportunity left, right?
Can't be this simple. It can't be this easy. But it was. I had mascara on. Not a tear came out when I did this onion. It really was brilliant.
I was thinking, this is going to be hard and hard to clean, and it was just so easy to clean. It was opposite.
Whatever it is you're trying to make, just put all the ingredients in, a few turns, and it's done.
Ever since the beginning of time, mankind has been
searching I don't think
for
it's going to be there.
Make life easier in the kitchen. From the Stone Age to the Machine Age, our kitchens have become cluttered with expensive
it's
kitchen
the meth
machines
lab again.
To take up space and collect dust. Well, now the art of cooking blasts off into the space age with Rocket Chef. Snap, seal, and save lid, and the mess is a thing of the past. To order Rocket Chef for just two low payments of $19.95, have your credit card ready and call this toll-free number. Discover what space age cooking is.
Back, we're in the culinary kitchen. This is so much fun with the Rocket Chef. John, I don't want to lose any time. You promised ice cream. Let's have it.
Nancy, you can make ice cream with the Rocket Chef rocket fast because after all...
Ice cream? Can you really?
Sugar, eggs and cream. You simply blend them together into a custard and then, of course, you add the flavor of your choice. You know,
okay.
Vanilla, for example.
Sure.
Now, what about a few chocolate chips in there?
Ooh, what about any flavor we want?
Any
Doesn't
you want. Then all you
good?
Do is simply give
okay.
it a turn.
Uh-huh.
And then all you've got to do, Nancy, is take it to the freezer. Do you
all
know
right,
what?
Yes.
And just give it a turn a few times before it freezes. And look at this, Nancy. Oh, ice cream. You want to try some?
Oh, let's
You ready
see.
To try some? Okay, Nancy. Try it. Tell me what you think.
Oh, you guys, that is so much better than good. There's nothing like homemade
but
ice cream.
You know
That's
what?
Fabulous.
Nancy, don't limit yourself to vanilla ice cream. What about all the family favorites? I mean, the kids are going to love strawberry ice cream, chocolate ice cream.
Yeah.
Look, there's
that
a
probably works.
Yogurt, and How about a mango orange?
Jerma, you promised us $40 million.
Nancy, you can do it all.
I didn't do anything. I watched the same commercial you did.
I mean, Nancy, just look at the way it's eating up that celery. You know, blades that slice stick off in.
But what?
Remember, you're going to get perfect professional slices time and time again. And Nancy, you tell me, what's the worst job in the kitchen?
Onions.
Why is that, Nancy?
Because they bring tears.
Not anymore. You've got onions without tears because the odors are locked inside. How about blended drinks? I mean, fruit smoothies, chocolate milkshakes, power drinks, diet drinks. And you know what, Nancy? You can do turkey salad, chicken salad, tuna salad, crab salad, shrimp salad.
Can we just watch this whole infomercial and get 1993 clickbaited?
Rocket fuel for your family. What do you think, Nancy?
John, I think you promised you would take us right into the space age. You'd save us a lot of money. We could get rid of all of those other things. You did it!
I'd say so.
Yes,
with the rocket ship.
With the rocket ship. What do you guys think?
Onion ice cream? No, that's what that was, an onion ice cream.
But, John Parkin, I'm
wait, was it even part of the same commercial?
This has been a paid advertisement for Rocket Chef, presented by Culinaire. The program you are watching is a paid advertisement for Rocket Chef, presented by Culinaire.
Don't touch that remote. During the next few minutes, we'll tell you about a $40 million giveaway promotion. You can get the fabulous Rocket Chef for a friend absolutely free. And for yourself, you'll get the amazing Fat-Free Gourmet, a $30 value also free. This cooking breakthrough lets you cook food in its own rich flavors and aromas with fewer calories, nicer, chop better. Yes, that one appliance is here. Stay saving Fat-Free. It's the only can of...
Our kitchen, I am Nan.
What happened? What happened? That's okay. All right, we got another amazing discoveries. Alpha Netics. We have the Red Devil Grill. This looks really crunchy. I'm gonna put this one on.
Smoked meats for real old-fashioned barbecue. Absolutely anywhere you go with the revolutionary Red Devil, the portable outdoor kitchen from Quantum Homewares.
Hey, Greg.
Hey, Mick. What a spread.
Everything looks
what
so
a
delicious.
Spread.
Thanks.
Hey, Mick, who catered this?
No one.
It's so hot. What a terrible day to be cooking in the kitchen.
Didn't even go in the kitchen.
Then how did you make all this incredible-looking food?
That's why
it's
I
so much food.
Everybody here today. I want to show you something Mimi and I have found that is so revolutionary. It has literally changed the way we think about cooking. Every single dish
that's like
was prepared.
50 pounds of food.
Fried is raw, so you get perfectly cooked food
it's a grill.
And every time.
And just because it's portable doesn't mean that it's small.
Hey, Rob, I see you've got 15 burgers and $5.
Why there's so much food?
$100 grill that's never ever gonna leave.
Wait. Freeze. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. There are like 13 people here. There's like 40 people's worth of food already here. They start putting burgers on a grill. There's like 15 patties here already. And this motherfucker over here has... Somebody, you guys need to communicate with each other. You guys need to communicate. You don't cook food over here. Like, I got this already going, man. There's like three or four people making three or four different parties amounts of food.
On that big $400 grill that's never ever gonna leave the backyard.
And we've got 15 burgers and five dogs on the Red Devil, and I can take it anywhere.
What?
More than 250 square inches of cooking surface means that there's enough room to cook food for all your friends and family.
But remember, the Red Devil isn't a grill.
It's a portable outdoor kitchen.
Looks like a grill to me.
They're your friends.
I know. If all the Red Devil was a barbecue that I could take with me fishing or tailgating, it'd be terrific.
Getting called out.
But believe me, the best is yet to come.
This is the Red Devil Super Skillet.
This is what really makes a Red Devil a complete outdoor kitchen.
It's a grill.
The grilling rack and the radiant heat plate. Got the Super Skillet over the high output burner, and now I can.
It's a man-sized skillet.
My kitchen stove. Outdoors without any pots or pans.
Let me show you what I mean.
No, stop making food.
Mimi, The next time we go tailgating with your folks, I'm having some of my famous three bean Texas.
Right now, like Jack over there is like.
The meat starts to brown. It's just like cooking it in your kitchen. Look how easy that is. All you do now is you add your beans, okay? Then we add our other beans.
Right.
Did I turn this off?
Season on the top.
Did I turn the grill off?
With the sauce. And just take a look at this. Now, we just mix it all together. And in about 5 minutes, it will all be done. Just take a look at this. Wouldn't chili be a nice addition to your family's tailgating on a
what
cold winter's day instead of boring burgers and boring dogs?
Boring? I love burgers and dogs on the grill.
Would you prefer salmon?
Not on this.
White wine done in a nice creamy dill sauce. It just
not okay, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, guys. You bring this to a tailgating party, you're gonna the record is gonna scratch, and you're gonna people are gonna be like, a tailgating? You're gonna go tailgating and make salmon and potatoes in a white wine sauce? That's not gonna. I don't think people are gonna care.
It just takes the same time as it does to grill it.
That is delicious. But you know what? I actually thought you were gonna say fish and chips.
Well, that's possible too.
All these people are here. These people don't fucking want to be in a commercial. It's just like they just started to do an advertisement now. Look at the reactions. They're kind of just like, what the fuck are you guys doing,
that
man?
That is delicious. But you know what?
Look at, like, what's going on over there? This guy's reading a book.
I actually thought you were going to say fish and chips.
Well, that's possible too. Because all you need to do now is add a little bit of oil, and the red devil turns into a cordless deep fryer.
What do you do with the oil?
Hot, fresh fish and chips.
What do you do with the oil?
When was the last time you had fried chicken, the very best picnic food? Crispy, hot, cooked up fresh?
What do you do with the oil?
Look at that.
Beautiful.
Just pour it out?
All, the curved design,
pour it into the ground?
International dishes. It makes the perfect portable wok.
Fry up my shrimp in my wok at the tailgating party.
If you want to use chicken, if you want to use beef, and that's fine. You can use whatever suits you, because the only thing that limits you with the Red Devil is your imagination. Just take a look at that. Now, I serve this to my family and friends, and every time I serve it, it goes down the tree. Just take a look at that. Isn't
goes
that
down
delicious?
The tree. Wait, it goes
it's
down
like
the tree?
It really is the perfect wok, but there's a much more important reason for this curved design.
Ah, that's right. You see, what happens is...
Somebody said he's just describing what cooking is.
It's the shape.
He's still over there.
I don't know. You tell him, Amy.
Oh, my God. This guy. This poor guy. This poor guy. Somebody tell him. Somebody tell him to stop doing
really
that.
Very simple. Once you place the super skillet over the high
He's
output burner, this parabolic shape directs the flame up and out over the curved surface, creating three distinct heating zones. The center is for medium heat.
Three heating
the
zones?
Around that is the hot zone, and around the edges is for warming.
It's just like having a multi-burner stove that folds up and fits right in the trunk of your car.
Exactly. You can cook
He's
complete
still cooking.
Multi-course meals for the
Dude,
entire family
look at all this.
With no more time and trouble than it takes to cook those same old burgers and dogs.
In fact, let me show you. Here's a meal you'd never dream of cooking on an outdoor grill. Breakfast. Now, all bacon and sausage need to be cooked on a high heat.
To cook those same old burgers and dogs.
In
fact,
look at his
reaction. Here's a meal you'd never dream of cooking on an
outdoor grill. You can't believe it.
Breakfast. Now, all bacon and sausage need to be cooked on a high heat. But we're going to put them on the middle ring, remember? That's the hot zone. Now, when you'll find your cooking meat on the super skillet...
Still, he goes back to cooking, still?
Because it takes longer to cook.
And you know what? With the Red Devil, you can please everyone.
This guy is freaking me out.
Which might be something that someone might want.
I think he's freezing. Is he moving?
I'm just gonna put that in the hot
Guys, he's not moving.
Eggs. I'm gonna take my eggs and I'm gonna put them in the center. Remember, that's the medium zone, and just take a look at that. And you know the best bit? Thanks to the three distinct heating zones, all the food finishes together. For instance, your bacon doesn't go cold while you're waiting for your eggs to cook. Just look at that.
Exactly. And you know what? I have some sweet rolls here that we need to warm up.
Well, let's put them around the outside then, because remember...
I love that so much.
Warming zone.
Whoa, exactly. What are you doing with all these sweet rolls?
We are cooking an entire breakfast all at once, all in one pan.
That's right. Complete meals for the whole family. Less time and less trouble than it takes grilling
dogs.
Okay. Right, so the kids can have frankfurters and beans.
Exactly.
What?
Dad's gonna love this one.
Oh my God, that's right. Philly cheesesteaks. Authentic
Philly
cheesesteaks.
Who made this?
Look at this. The vegetables are sizzling.
They didn't cook this.
There on the medium heat.
That looked beautiful.
The meat's warming in the hot sun and the buns right
there.
This
got recalled.
Isn't that beautiful?
Delicious. But I gotta tell you, Mimi, here's my favorite.
What's that?
Fajitas.
Oh.
Now, first I grill my chicken and my beef.
Right.
Round the hot zone. Just add my peppers, add my onions, and then you just mix it all together. And in less time and trouble than it takes grilling a piece of chicken, I can be enjoying beautiful fajitas.
Fajitas.
On the deck of my friend's boat. Now we take the flour tortillas, put them around the warming zone of chicken. I can be enjoying beautiful fajitas. Look at that. On the deck of my friend's boat.
The deck of your friend's boat? Don't you guys love how you're starting to see through the bullshit a little bit here? Tailgating. Bring it to a tailgating party. Tailgate hot dogs. Yeah, hot dogs and hamburgers. Tailgating. Cooked salmon in a white wine sauce on the deck of my friend's boat. Yeah. Okay. So. Interesting. Oh, it's about to the tailgating, though.
Now we take the flour tortillas, put them around the warming zone, and now, once again, we've got complete meals for the whole family. Just look at that.
That's great. But watch this. Here's where it gets really handy. Simply connect the Stay Cool handle.
Dude, they're just walking away from all this shit.
Carry the super skillet to the table. Set it on the Red Devil serving cradle. And dig in.
Look at that. From cookware to heated servingware. In seconds.
And one less pan to clean.
And that's the way fajitas are served.
All these things.
On a sizzling hot plate.
They're going to come back one time, and one of these is going to be on fire, and he's going to be, like, putting it out with a fucking bedsheet or something. Like, this guy is still here.
The food stays warm.
And it's a fun way to eat.
But we're still not done. While you're eating, plop the grill back over the burner and put the kettle on for some after-dinner coffee.
Now you can cook directly over the high-output burner. Ta-da! It's a camping stove. So you can boil rice or pasta, cook soups or stews, steam corn, even cook a lobster.
No one is going to do this.
At the beach, almost anywhere.
And if you think you might want to keep the leftovers warm, simply pick up the super skillet with a steak.
No, it's burgers. It's burgers, hot dogs, hamburgers, hot dogs, maybe like a piece of chicken wings, chicken thigh, like grilled fish is fine, right? But like, they're just trying to make up all these reasons to use it. No one's going to do that. It's like burgers and dogs and fish and foil and like, just be, no, but do it, like, be realistic about it. And maybe I would think about it. No pound cake, yeah.
Back to the Red Devil.
And the one touch temperature control to low.
And you've got a portable hot plate that'll keep your food warm for hours while you're out having fun.
I want this guy to be in the pool eventually, just swimming around.
At your backyard garden parties like today. Or it'd be great for wedding receptions or birthdays at the park.
But here's the best part. Since we cooked and served every one of these meals on this easy-to-clean enamel surface, simply take yourself a paper towel or a
towel. On the ground.
Whatever you've got handy.
He's brushing it on the ground.
Fold up the super skillet and pop it into the carry case.
And because all...
Yeah, my friend's boat. Yeah, we're at my friend's house. Just wiping fucking charred bits on his ground.
All the surfaces you cooked on face in, you don't have to worry about getting grease all over everything.
Drop the heavy-duty grill stand down, close the legs, pop it into the carry case. Zip it up. Don't forget, there's a compartment here for the gas bottle as well.
And within a minute or two of having finished your meal, you're done and back to the fun.
Guys, I think my burgers are done. I bet you haven't. Like a burger, Rob? Man, I can't believe it. The Red Devil cooked those burgers as fast as my big backyard grill.
That's right, Rob. But remember, in the same time you cooked burgers and dogs on your grill, we made on the Red Devil Texas chili, sauteed fish and wine and dill.
Fish and chips, fried chicken, shrimp stir fry.
Also complete meals, beans and Franks, Philly cheesesteaks, even a complete breakfast.
Even chicken fajitas and lobster.
and we're only halfway done.
That's the instant.
More than 250 square inches of cooking surface means that there's enough room to cook food for all your friends and family.
But remember, the Red Devil isn't a grill.
It's a portable outdoor kitchen.
And each and every time.
And just because it's portable doesn't mean that it's small.
Hey, Rob, I see you've got 15 burgers and 5 dogs cooking on that big $400 grill that's never, ever going to leave the backyard.
And we've got 15...
So he knew. Why... was he acting like he didn't even know they were in his backyard? Right? Like, it's like, oh, hey, Rob, we're like cooking over here. You're not going to be able to beat us. And the guy turns around and it's like he's a fucking ghost.
Can't believe it.
Meal, you're done. And
like, watch this.
Fun.
Guys, I think my burgers are done. I bet you haven't.
Like a burger, Rob?
Man, I can't believe it. The Red Devil cooked those burgers as fast as my big backyard grill.
That's right, Rob. Remember,
and we made
same...
lobster. Oh my God, this is so ridiculous.
Wine and dill.
Fish and chips. Fried chicken. Shrimp stir fry.
Also complete meals. Beans and Franks. Philly cheese steaks. Even a complete breakfast.
Even chicken fajitas and lobster.
And we're only halfway done.
Yeah, he had five grills.
Instant oven Superdome.
And when we come back, we'll show you how the Superdome package
turns your Red Devil into a roaster,
a smoker,
a steamer,
a poacher, even an outdoor oven that lets you bake breads, cakes, and what I've got cooking right now. Mick's favorite food and something I'm sure you've never seen cooked outdoors before.
No.
What is it?
You'll see. So keep enjoying your food and we'll be right back to...
Okay, where's part two? I want it right now. Did I do part two? I think I queued it up already. Yep, this far. Thank God, part two.
Get your hands off that. That's dessert. I want to show them the rest of this first.
Okay, but that better be good.
Don't worry.
Dessert.
Okay, say you're watching your favorite football team and it's their most important game of the season. So you're out in the stadium parking lot tailgating.
And guess what?
Back to the tailgating.
Right, so burgers and dogs just aren't going to cut it. I mean, in this country, Thanksgiving means one thing. Turkey with all the trimmings.
Wait, it got recalled? It was... people being burned and set on fire? What? Holy shit. The intake tube can warm up to as high as 750 degrees. What the fuck? It would get so hot that it would collapse. Holy shit. Oh my God.
And for that, you're going to need an oven.
Are you serious?
For that, you're going to need the Red Devil Superdome, especially designed to work in conjunction with the Super Skillet to turn your Red Devil into a portable oven.
So now you can have family feasts anywhere, including the big game on Thanksgiving.
Exactly. Simply put your turkey, chicken, or even a prime rib.
No turkey. No turkeys, man. No, don't put a turkey in here. Holy shit.
On a specially designed roasting rack,
don't put a turkey
in here. Put your vegetables around the outside, and the special shape of the Superdome circulates the heat so efficiently that in less time than it takes to roast in your kitchen oven,
you can have a delicious Thanksgiving dinner absolutely anywhere.
So how does this end?
Phil, we've got something you're going to love under this one. Now, you don't believe in barbecue sauce, right?
Right.
You believe that true barbecue should be smoked, right?
Look at this.
Wait a second. Hold on.
Delicious Thanksgiving.
Hold on. Why is this guy the authority on food here? What, on barbecue?
Absolutely anywhere.
Right. Hold on, did you see that?
Phil, we've got...
Phil, and he's like, yep.
Something you're going to love under this one. Now, you don't believe in barbecue sauce, right?
Right.
What do you mean, I don't believe in barbecue sauce? And you can tell that Phil is fucking annoying, by the way, at these parties. Like, he every time somebody brings up barbecue, you know that he's going to spend like 20 minutes talking about it. So they got to convince Phil.
You believe that true barbecue should be smoked, right?
Look at this.
And it's like they're calling him out. Like, He's this barbecue authority at the party.
Just add moist wood chips underneath the grilling rack.
Oh my goodness gracious.
And you can cook meats like delicious smoked turkey, even real old-fashioned barbecue ribs.
And that's you think the they can convince Phil?
Smoking gives the meat that delicious barbecue flavor all the way through. Mimi, try this. You ready?
Ooh.
Whoa, beef brisket. Now let's just check the meat here and see if it's done.
Wait, what is this thing?
Press the button. Yes, it is. Oh, you ready? Just try this.
Mmm, that's delicious. But Rick, what is that?
That's the optional Perfect Chef grilling fork with a built-in meat thermometer. It takes the guesswork out of cooking, whether you're indoors and out. Simply press the button and the light will tell you exactly how your meat is cooked every time.
That's a great idea.
It's the perfect companion to your portable smoking and roaster machine.
All right, we're almost done with this one, but I'm... This is so... This is bizarre.
Why don't you head off back down to the beach for some delicious clam bake?
Ooh, look at that.
Clam bake.
It's a steamer that
what
you can take
about?
With you anywhere.
What about Phil?
Perfect for steaming fresh vegetables or add a little bit of fish stock or a little bit of wine. And
wait, I want to know. I got to see the end
but
of Phil's
the very
arc.
Best thing is the special design of the Superdome system. The heat radiates so evenly that I can literally cook anything I can cook in my oven, outdoors, any from cornbread.
Look.
All American. Meatloaf and cornbread.
Look at that. And that's baking outdoors.
Ready for dessert?
What?
I baked a cake.
You baked a cake outdoors?
Not just any cake, your favorite. Pineapple? Upside down cake.
But you don't have to do this.
That's great. As you can-
but you don't have to do that. Just make a grill, man. Like, make a grill. And, like, look, make a good grill. That's like outdoors and what I like a good grill. Doesn't have to bake a cake.
So you really can cook anything, anywhere with the Red Devil portable outdoor kitchen. I mean, give me some of that, will you?
Now you can cook anything, anywhere, with the revolutionary Red Devil, the portable outdoor kitchen from Quantum Homewares. Compact and portable, the Red Devil goes anywhere you go.
Okay, all right.
It's even a portable oven.
All right, okay.
With no more time in trouble than
okay,
grilled
here we
burgers
go.
And dogs. Let's see what they thought.
All right, let's see what they think.
Hey, Jack.
Hey, Pete.
Hi.
What have you got cooking there?
Pasta primavera.
Wow.
Wait great. A second.
Yeah, we're big campers. You know, usually we only get to eat back.
Wait, hold on. Hold on. Guys, what the fuck is happening in this video? What is happening in this video?
Yeah. Pasta primavera.
They're cooking pasta on the grill?
Wow.
That looks great.
Yeah, we're big campers. You know, usually we only get to eat mac and cheese.
Oh, is that all you get? How long did this take you?
What we do is we use the grill on top to boil water for the pasta. Then after that, we saute the vegetables. We put the pasta in, mix it all together, and then we grill the garlic bread right on top in the skillet. Hmm. Now,
why? That looks fantastic. Explain why you did that and not... In a pot. Why did you do this? Why? Explain to me why. No, explain why. Why do it here? Like, well, seriously, that's what I would do.
We can have two or three things, a whole meal at once.
Thanks, Jack. Thanks
Pete.
Hi, Angela.
Hi, Shane.
Hi.
How you doing?
Look at this. This looks great. What have you got here?
Well, we've got chicken nuggets, and we have grilled cheese sandwiches.
Ah, grilled cheese sandwiches.
Mm, that's my favorite.
Now, tell me, Angela,
Now, tell me, why? You have a toaster oven that's inside of your RV right now. It's perfectly fine. Why did you do this on the grill? Explain to me why.
What's your favorite thing about the Red Devil when you're out?
Well, when we go picnicking with the kids, it can be a little finicky. So with this, we can put a wide variety of foods and cook them at the same time, and everybody can have what they like.
Oh, that's great.
So what's your favorite thing about the chain?
Well, it even cooks pizza, too. I love pizza.
Hi, Ida.
Hi, Ida.
Don't tell people to make pizza on a grill like that. Right? Like...
Gary?
Hamburgers. Hot dogs.
Hi,
How are you doing?
Gotta tell you, that looks great.
What the fuck is that?
Well, we put the chicken in first.
Right.
And let it go for about a half an hour.
Uh-huh.
And then you add the vegetables, whatever you want in it. You can put onions, you can put just about anything in the world that you like. And then the dough on, and it just cooks great.
Doesn't that make a change from burgers and dogs?
Oh, yeah, yeah. In fact, we used to use the microwave all the time in the RV.
Do you go RV in Ida?
Yes, we do.
And what do you think about this for taking?
Well, grilled pizza is good. That was a bad take.
The RV very nicely. Plus, usually we use microwave food a lot, and this is much tastier, I think.
Thanks, Ida.
Thanks, Gary.
I think they proved it. You really can't
what about Phil?
Anything.
Anywhere with the Red Devil Portable Outdoor Kitchen.
What do you guys got on here? Somebody said human meat. Oh, they've got, you got, what other weird shit do you guys have underneath there? You got, you're cooking pasta on the grill. You're cooking, what do you got, chicken nuggets? What's in here? Oh, let's say it's a human leg. You know, we... Okay, human legs and human arms sometimes.
Me and Ida?
Yes, we do.
And what do you think about this for taking?
Oh, it's compacting needle.
Oh, that's not as weird as the pasta. But still fucked up, by the way. Still incredibly fucked up.
Fit into the RV very nicely. Plus, usually we use microwave food a lot. And this is much tastier.
Where's Phil?
Thanks, Gary.
Where's Phil?
I think they proved it. You really can cook anything.
Anywhere with the Red Devil Portable Outdoor Kitchen.
Well, best of all, you can try it risk-free.
That's right. Take it to your next picnic. Take it to a tailgate party. Try it out in your own backyard before you decide to keep it.
And if you can't cook all of your favorite foods absolutely anywhere, Quantum Homewares will refund your purchase price.
This is crazy.
No questions asked.
Even better, if you call right on the next nice day.
Devil Portable Outdoor.
Okay,
cool. Hey, save some for me.
What? Hungry, I'm gonna eat.
Hey!
Kitchen. Now I'm getting hungry. I'm gonna eat.
Hey, save some for me.
Now you can cook any.
I'd be concerned. If I went to a backyard barbecue and there was a full, like, 30-pound turkey on the table and it was like, I cooked this on the grill, I'd go, I'm not eating that. I am not gonna cut into that one. That's something I'm going to avoid. I'm not going to eat this, right? It's going to be like, oh, that's cool. I guess what you just told me is sort of interesting. Like, you cooked something like that on the grill like this. I'm not going to eat it. That's crazy. That's crazy. Wild, wild world of infomercial products. Now that we saw the that grill, how about the micro grill? How about the Bissell Big Green? I don't know what this one is, but we're gonna watch it. We're gonna turn that way fucking down. Tracking. Oh my god, the crusty tracking.
Up next on Helpful Hints.
Helpful Hints.
Oh, now that's ruined. No, it's not. Watch those messes disappear in seconds with today's Helpful Hint. Bissell's Big Green.
Like, I was trying to adjust the volume and was hitting tracking. Yup.
Able to take on even the toughest stains in seconds. Doing jobs no single machine is.
Are you sucking shit out of the sink?
Welcome to host of Helpful Hints.
Duh, I'm interested completely in this one. What are you sucking out of the sink?
Helpful Hints, we're going to take on the problem of dirt and stains. Now, for many of you, it's a battle you've been losing on the home front. But today, we're going to introduce you to a brand new secret weapon. It's fast, it's easy to use, and it promises to make dirt and stains in your home a thing of the past.
Okay.
And this is it. It's called the Big Green Clean Machine, and it's made by Bissell.
That's a great name.
They're the
already.
Authority when it comes to cleaning carpets, floors, and upholstery. And here to show us how it works is a woman who's helped all of America with her Helpful Hints. She's the creator of Mary Ellen's Wow Laundry Stain Removers.
Cool.
Over 14 million of you have bought her Helpful Hints books.
Uh-huh.
She's been on just about every talk show in the country, and you read her column in every issue of Woman's Day. Please welcome Mary Ellen Pinkham.
Hello, here we go. Hi, everybody.
I love her.
Nice to see you.
I love her already.
I'm a woman that solves problems.
Mm-hmm.
big ones and little ones like this. How do you get the last drops of ketchup out of a bottle?
Well, the way I do it is usually the old...
If she sucks it out of a vacuum cleaner, I'm going to fucking shit my pants.
Grab the bottom of the bottle like this, and then swing it in circular motion, and see? It drops it to the net.
Can you see it? It's all down there?
Yeah.
Hey, a helpful hint right off the top of the show.
Do me a favor. Make sure the cap is on tightly when you're swinging, or you're going to have...
Wait, that was just a helpful hint.
Stains galore.
All right, and messes are what we came to talk about today, right?
You better believe it, and messes can be cleaned up with this.
Wait, that was her opener. It was like, hey, here's a hint. Like,
I love it. You
whip
know,
your ketchup around.
I've endorsed many products throughout the years, but I never have until this machine, because it's going to change the way we all clean our homes, kind of just like microwave changed the way we cook.
New technology.
Yeah, so now here we
yeah,
go.
Yeah, new technology, a fucking vacuum cleaner.
Okay. Number one, it's a state-of-the-art vacuum cleaner, and you're not going to need vacuum cleaner bags any longer.
No more replacement bags you have to buy in the store?
No more. And it makes the greatest wet back. Boy, I'll tell you, here we've got a bowl of cherry Kool-Aid. Now let's... show you how fast.
What are we going to put this right in here?
All right. Absolutely.
Look at that. Just going right down.
Look at how quick that works. Look at that power.
Do you see?
Whoa. Look at that.
And then it goes. You see, we added a funny burp for the kids.
A big stain picker up
there.
There
we go. It's all gone.
Wow. All right. That's powerful, Mary Ellen.
And because of that power, it makes the greatest deep cleaning extraction machine that you could use to clean your carpet, your upholstery, your floors, your car, your boat, your RVs, things that are big and things that are very expensive.
All right, now those are pretty big claims you're making here, so let's make you prove them, all right? We've collected the dirty dozen of stain makers. Come on over to this
my
table.
My favorite.
And this is really a collection of the things that make the worst stains in your home.
What is, what makes the, okay, that fucking click sound is going to kill me.
A little coffee, that always ends up on
the counter. Coffee stains.
How about some chocolate milk?
Chocolate milk, oh yeah.
Some pet stains.
Well, just, we understand what you mean by that. We don't have to add anything.
All right.
It's like a jar of dog piss?
That's great. And, that's it. Let's
okay, should we stir it up here?
What do you mean, that's it?
Okay,
the perfect done. That was not that much wine. That was barely any wine.
Usually on my carpet.
That's right. Everybody's carpet.
Okay, we have some carpet
out
here for you.
Now, you've got your choice, which you've got a low pile, a Berber, and a high pile. And what are we going to do?
He takes it back. She's like, oh, we don't have any dog urine we can use. And he's like, hold on just a second. And he like goes off stage and he's like, this is into it for a second and goes back in.
Okay, I would say the Berber because it's the most expensive and it's the lightest color. This will be the hardest for you to get out, I think.
Okay, so let's spill it like we do at home.
Just pour it on. Okay, here it goes.
Oh, what the? Oh, no.
Well, usually, on the way to get to clean it up, I step in it. So let's grind it in here for you, make it tough for you.
What do you do next?
Well, then I grab anything absorbent, somebody's skirt, a shirt, a paper towel, and I get down on my hands and knees.
And you say a little prayer that'll come out.
Please come out. All right.
Okay.
And then I like smush it all around and clean it up and then take some soap and put it on there.
Oh, you're doing absolutely the wrong thing. First of all, you're just moving that stain and you're making it bigger and bigger. It's going down into the padding of the carpet. And guess what? The soap just attracts more dirt.
Wait, soap attracts dirt?
It does unless you get it all up. So you've got a blot and blot and blot, and that's almost impossible. Hasn't it happened to you? You've gone to bed at night and the stain's gone. You wake up in the morning and
it's back again. That's true.
That's
it actually does happen.
Oh,
it is actually. It's stupid.
And
I hate it.
It is the annoying. Big green clean machine.
Okay, now Mary Ellen, how does this work?
It works easily. You can set this whole thing up in less than 1 minute, and it eliminates a big mess because it's got two tanks, one for the clean water and then one for the dirty water.
All right, so,
it's got dual tube technology.
Outer tank here for the clean, dirty inside, so it separates the dirty from the clean. You wouldn't want to clean with dirty water, I guess.
Absolutely, okay. And the cleaning solution is marvelous. You just put it in the
clean
water.
So that's a special proprietary cleaning solution.
The vacuum switch, and then the pump switch. The pump will spray on.
I just want one of them just like turn it on and be like, and like everybody laughs.
Okay, Joe, turn on that machine and let's go get that stain.
That's very dangerous too, don't do that. Listen to this audience. Listen to this fucking audience. It's like, they're like kind of like heckling a little. Like they can't believe this shit. But getting a stain out of a carpet, it's not that hard. You just have to be persistent and have the right cleaning tools.
It is the big green clean machine. One clean.
So it's separate.
Listen to this.
Now I release the trigger.
Look at it. Can you see it?
I'm just imagining like a fucking large soda gets like thrown down here. and hits the back wall. Like, no fucking way.
I can smell this too. It smells great.
Yeah, it smells like you've been cleaning all day long. Now what do? You take the tank and you dump it in the toilet, and the stain will go down the drain.
All right.
I want you to try.
I get to try now?
I want you to pick a stain, pick a tub
stain. Pick a stain. Okay, how about ketchup right here?
And we're going to clean the sofa. You know, people are scared to death to clean their upholstered furniture, fearing that it's going to become waterlogged.
Yeah, it's full of stuff. You don't want to get it wet.
No more. Just pick up the big green clean machine.
Okay, right.
All right, so we're going to do ketchup.
Light?
Yeah, that wasn't bad at all. You can just take it from room to room and follow spots wherever they happen, right?
Absolutely. Now let's lay that ketchup stain down.
Okay, I'll take the top off, and here we go. Little dollop right there. Okay, I'm going to mix it in right there. How's that? Okay,
pretty
now.
Disgusting.
Now, while we're waiting for
this. That's not even. People are acting like he shit on the couch.
I've got a great one.
He didn't.
Okay, and that's pet hair all over your soul. I've got a great one.
He didn't get on the couch and like shit on it.
I've got a great one for pet lovers, okay? And that's pet hair all over your sofa, your chairs. It's a real mess. In the past, I used to tell people to fill a spray bottle with water, then spritz down their furniture, and then take a brush and brush off all that pet hair. No more. The big green clean machine.
Just use one of those rollers.
Because of this special attachment that's made for upholstery. Okay?
All right.
Same formula and everything.
It's useful.
And that's all there's to it. And the pet hair is gone like magic.
All right, another great helpful hint here.
You would literally buy anything if there was a wholesome, sweet, middle-aged woman telling you to do it.
Look at that. Isn't that amazing?
That's not true.
Okay, I'm going to pull. There you go. Look at that. And I'm just extracting the water.
You just saved this couch from a very costly mistake.
Would have been very expensive.
Now,
it was easy to do, by the way. I just pulled the trigger, put the water and cleaning solution down, and it pulled it right up.
And it's not very wet at all. It'll be dry by morning. Now, I'll tell you what, I want to introduce
this shit does work,
that
though. It's like a carpet cleaner, guys. The carpet cleaner is the same technology. He's
the big green clean machine.
Eric. Hi, Joe.
Like a doctor? Who is this?
I've got to tell you, with what I've seen so far, very, very impressive. Congratulations.
This is just the beginning. This machine is three machines in one. It's a dry vacuum cleaner, it's a wet shop vacuum, and it's a deep cleaning machine, $500 worth of machines.
And this machine is as powerful as all those machines.
I mean, they've been using this same exact technology for like 50 years. It works.
A very powerful motor. In fact, I will show you later that it can unclog a drain.
All right, we'll hold them to that, won't we? I want to see that demonstration.
Right now, I'm going to show you just how powerful it is as a dry vacuum. Mary Ellen, if you turn that on, it can handle dirt.
That's not impressive.
Even nuts and bolts.
Why are they cheering?
Thanks, Joe. Now, if you'd hand me the bowling ball and attachment under that counter.
Okay, you're not going to try and suck up the bowling ball through here. Won't fit up the hose.
Oh, no. There's no way that's going to work.
All right. You'll put that attachment on there. You'll see it's clear.
Right.
No strings or wires in there.
Nothing up his sleeve.
Now, John, what I'm going to do is I'm going to lie down on the table. And I'm going to lie facing up on the table. What I want you to do is hold the bowling ball over my face. And I trust the suction. I created this goddamn product. Ooh, be careful.
All right. Show the people that it's no glue on there.
Okay, just...
Now, Mary Ellen, if you'll turn that powerful motor on.
Okay, we're going to put it here.
Yeah.
Now, shake it.
That's how much I trust it.
Yeah. Now, watch your feet. Watch your feet. Oh, that is powerful. Eric, that was incredible. All right, now, we heard you were going to do a demonstration like that, and when we heard that, we decided to devise a little test of our own here. Right now, I'd like to introduce you to someone who's very near and dear to Mary Ellen's heart. This is her husband, Tom, who's standing by outside our studio. Hi,
what?
Tom.
Hi, honey.
Mary Ellen, I think you've gone a little bit too far this time.
What is he rigged up to?
If you pull the camera back just a little bit, you'll see that Tom is in the hot seat, or maybe the cool seat, because underneath him, can you see that?
Are they going to put it on his head?
Water. Now, as you can see, we've got a big green clean machine set up out there.
And this is
what we're going to do.
If we
get the machine on, okay, we've got a situation set up just like Eric's test. We're going to put a bowling ball.
Oh,
any time during the rest of the show, that motor fails or burns out under the stress, that ball is going to fall off right onto his
head.
And Tom, you know what's going to happen, don't you, old friend?
You owe me for this one!
I thought they were going to put it on his head and turn it on and suck his head and then drop the lever as if he was going to fall into the water. And I thought I was going to keep him up by holding his head. Okay.
I don't think he has anything to worry about, but there's something about the big green clean machine that's better than anything else you've seen so far.
Hold on. I got to get this ready. This is important. This is important. Just bear with me for one second, please. I'm gonna go away for a sec.
Situation set up just like Eric's test. We're gonna put a bowling ball in there, and if any time during the rest of the show that motor fails or burns out under the stress, that ball is gonna fall off right onto a switch. And Tom, you know what's gonna happen, don't you, old friend?
You owe me for this one.
I don't think he has anything to worry about, but there's something about the we've seen so far, because we have been cleaning our homes the wrong way. Joe, if your hair was dirty, what would you do?
Trick question. I'd wash it.
If your shirt was dirty, what would you do?
What the fuck is this?
If you vacuumed your hair and your shirt, what would you call them?
I call them dirty and me stupid, I guess. That doesn't work.
Exactly. Vacuum cleaning only gets the dirt on top. The big green clean machine deep cleans. It injects a warm solution that grabs the deep down dirt.
Is he all right?
Fibers, and then extracts
everything. Wait, who else? Somebody went in to get him. Somebody went in to get him.
Leaves behind. In fact, we had an independent lab run a study for us, and this is what they did. They took an ordinary vacuum cleaner, went into a 9x9
Save him.
Vacuumed out as much dirt as they could get, and this is what they got. 13 grams of dirt.
Turn up face cam.
Exactly. Then they went in with the big green clean machine, cleaned the same carpet that the vacuum had first crack at, dried down the water.
Now I'm back.
Left in there. 23 more grams of dirt.
Wow.
What I missed everything.
Dirt was still in the carpet. All this was left behind after vacuuming.
Exactly.
Look at all that dirt. Mary Ellen.
Now, girls, what these guys are trying to say with all their machines is this. All the vacuuming, all the scrubbing, even a team of Merry Maids is not going to get your home as clean as the big...
You owe me for this.
Now, let's go clean a floor. Come on, Joe. Now, Joe, the only difference when you're using the big green clean machine to clean floors is to use the special floor attachment. You want to grab that one over there?
Okay, this is it.
It snaps on very simply. Also, use the floor care formula that is absolutely marvelous for tile, vinyl, marble, lots of things, everything but wood, because everybody knows water cannot be used on wood floors.
Fuck his dumb ass shit.
Everybody but Joe, that is.
I just keep thinking of the guy in the water tank.
Okay, now. It's very easy to move around, and the canisters do not scuff the floor, and it's not top-heavy, so it's not going to tip over.
Okay, little casters on the bottom here keep it spinning smoothly. Eh?
Let's get this mess turned on.
Okay.
All right, here we go.
Took a swipe right through there. Look at that.
No streaking.
Holy shit.
That was great.
Okay. What happens when you're watering a hanging plant?
Well, usually I pour the water in up here and it comes right down the drain holes and goes all over the floor.
And it makes a mess. Now you're going to understand why
you
I sold
watering...
15 million books. On watering day, all you need is a umbrella.
You're... Oh, no. No, 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 no. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no, 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 no.
What happens? We've been talking about stains here now, but what happens when a stain really gets set in? What do you do then?
Now, that's a toughie, but come on over here, and I'm going to show you what a great job the big green clean machine does.
Okay, now on this step, we have grape juice
and
in
that is tough. Mm-hmm. All you have to do is turn on the pump.
Just the pump.
And pre-treat the stain by just laying down the cleaning solution.
Okay, just spray on the cleaning
solution.
Just like
that.
Like this.
Now,
okay.
Go have a cup of coffee. Mm-hmm. Or maybe I'll give you a helpful hint. Well, that does the job.
I'd like that.
Okay?
Oh, another helpful. I actually want to hear this.
That you can remove chewing gum from carpeting with WD-40.
No way.
Spritz it on and rub it out. That's all there's to it. And then you can remove the WD-40 with your big green clean machine.
You want to take that up? Very helpful hint. Chewing gum right up there. Okay, now how about our stain? Has this been treated long enough?
Okay, that should do it. Now you turn on the pump and the vacuum. Now go for it. Look at that. Wow.
Excellent. Why can't I skip this ad? Is it blood? That wasn't blood. Yeah, some motherfucker is sitting right next to the camera's microphone in the audience, and their clapping is what you're hearing. That's what's going on. That's what you're hearing.
From the store.
Somebody's too close to the mic in the audience.
Because many times they end up looking like this, dirtier than the carpet you're going to clean. Yeah. And you know another thing that irks me? They sell you all these a la carte bottles. Foamers, anti-spotters, look at this one. Traffic lane cleaner, isn't that cute? And on it goes. It drives me crazy. Now this one bottle
missed one.
And you know what? It even has a formula to prevent future stains.
You can, it's, okay, you can tell just how unenthusiastic most people in the audience are. Because listen to we got somebody mic'd up. We have an audience member mic'd the fuck up. So we can tell every time they clap their hands. Every single time. And what they're doing is they're like kind of trying to blend in, like they don't really care. They're not participating. They don't really give a shit. And we can hear it in real time. We know how they feel in real time.
With this carpet care formula to do, let's say, a 10 by 10 room. With this formula in the big green clean machine, about $1.50. $1.50 for a 10 by 10 room.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Thanks, Eric.
5, 6.
Now let's switch gears here for a
second.
We wanted to find out how this machine compared in price to what the pros charge. Now, we've all seen deals advertised for $9.95 a room or $25 for 5 rooms. It seemed just too good to be true. Watch this. All right, now here's the situation as we've set it up. We've contacted a number of different carpet cleaning companies, the ones that usually send you these flyers in the mail, and normally they advertise low, low prices per room.
Uh-huh.
And we've asked them to give us an estimate based on 2 rooms, 2 hallways, and 3 pieces of living room furniture.
Why is this a prank?
Now, these estimates are going to be based on the same exact job that the big green clean machine can do. Now, they have no idea they're going to be on camera because we've hidden cameras all through the house. There's what they call a lipstick camera. Hi, Mom. That's a very small
camera. Is that really?
You can see it, and we've got microphones all over the house.
What? That's literally right there.
Here in the dining area, another lipstick camera up there. And our actress, Sharon, who's playing our housewife, will be seated here, hopefully getting the people giving us the estimates in these chairs. We'll be able to hear and see exactly what's going on.
This is fucking weird.
Don't you make yourself comfy?
Now, let me tell you something what to do. First thing for this carpet, what I can do is I'm going to show you a little demonstration what we do. We have a few kinds of cleaning jobs. Mm-hmm. Basic cleaning, deep cleaning, preconditioning, and more. It's all up to whatever you can afford. But the prices will be all together from, let's say, all together for around $500, $450. For the furniture and the carpet, $450, and
somebody said it's a ghost camp. Mm-hmm.
This will be the whole thing together.
You can't even hear.
$351.35 for the furniture, but that's with.
That's with everything.
To catch a cleaner.
$909.24.
Okay, that.
And that's for everything but the reef stretch. And.
Okay, wait a second. Say that again.
$909.24.
Now say that again. Say that again, but into this microphone that I have in front of you. No, can you say that into the pot of flowers, just real quick?
Out there, but I just don't want to have to call these guys in every time I've got a spill. Now remember, the way to prevent a spill from turning into a stain is to act fast.
All right, now let me see if I can summarize what we've seen here. The big green clean machine is a powerful vacuum cleaner that uses a reusable bag. It's also a powerful wet vac. It picked up that Kool-Aid in one gulp. It also deep cleaned some carpets, got out that really deep down dirt, and also gobbled up some of the worst stains I've ever seen, and replaced about $5 worth of cleaning.
Are we going to check in with the husband?
That's a lot of power and a lot of
equipment. That is really terrific. Now we're going to show you what you get. Will you help me out, Eric?
I sure will. Okay, Eric, what do we have here? We have the dry vacuum accessories, including the washable filter bag. We have the deep.
We need to check in with the husband, right?
We have the wet vac attachment to unclog the drain. Mm-hmm. We have the caddy organizer for your closet to keep everything handy. We have an instruction manual, and this is nice, an instructional videotape to get the best results from your machine. Sure. And to get you started, a bottle of the carpet care formula and the bare floor formula. That's a lot with this machine.
That's a lot.
There's more. And as my special gift to you, my new book, Mary Ellen's Wow, Helpful Hints That Really Work, Joe.
Wonderful. All thanks, right. Mary Ellen. All right.
Look, I kind of feel like...
Now, when we come...
Does anybody else feel like that book is actually kind of interesting? The Mary Ellen random hints. I'm like, look, spin the ketchup bottle around. I feel like that's a great bathroom book. I honestly feel like that would be... It's probably like just a bullet points of like thousands of little bullet points of like 2 or 3 sentences. Well, you just kind of go, oh, that's kind of funny. Even if it's like doesn't work. I feel like that's a great toilet book. I really do. I feel like that's like a cool, oh, that's fun. It's just life hacks. Yeah, but I don't know. If you're a 1993 grandmother, maybe. Would you buy a Mary Ellen joke book? You guys remember those? I would. Like, oh, funny little Mary Lynn's funny jokes. You remember those? It was like 500 pages long, and it was just these two sentence little jokey little quips. You guys remember those? I used to read them.
Back, we're going to see how Mary Ellen's doing high above that dunk tank. We're going to show you how this machine can unclog drains. We're going to tell you about some unwanted guests in your bedroom called dust mites. They've been living in your mattress, and this is what they look like. Yuck. And we're going to show you
how to get rid of them. Also, aren't you disgusted? You got to buy this now.
Machine, all when we return on Helpful Hints. Don't go away.
Introducing America's total cleaning system.
We gotta save this.
Green clean machine. It's three powerful cleaning machines in one. In the dry mode, it's a state-of-the-art dual filtration vacuum cleaner.
Dual filtration technology.
It's a wet vac that gobbles up spills in seconds, and it's a self-contained deep cleaning extraction machine for carpets, upholstery, and floors.
I like that. That looked like an iced coffee. That looked like an iced coffee advertisement with like the pillowing cream and the coffee. I like that.
That's the big green clean machine.
Wait, the guy's name is John Bissell? It's John Bissell. This is the man himself.
For carpets, upholstery, and
really?
It even
holy shit.
Drains, and it's quality built right here in the USA.
I believe that the big green clean machine is the finest unit that Bissell
holy shit. Actually, John Bissell.
We vacuum this carpet with an ordinary vacuum cleaner.
I use a Bissell. Thing works fucking great. Thing actually works great.
And we unleash the big green clean machine on the same carpet. And look at all the dirt ordinary vacuuming left behind. Now you can attack
the
worst stain nightmares when they happen. Just fill the big green clean machine with water. Then add the special carpet care formula.
Prove it.
The big green clean machine will pre-spot.
Right back. Back, but not quite. I'm gonna refill my drink. I'll be right back. Thank you. Okay. Here it is. The missile. Show it to you. Check it out. See? Not a liar. Missile. Take a look. Works great. It's got technology in it. This is abyssal. Suck up a bowling ball with it. Yeah, look, look. Look. Abyssal. Model number I use? I didn't just go to the store, stop. I don't want you to say the model number. I told you, it's abyssal. They work good. They're good. Got same day delivery. Oh, please. Hell yeah! Same day delivery, huh? Yeah, I just took it out of the box. Yeah, does that look like same? No, that's disgusting. That's gross. I was about to say same day delivery, huh, and show you what's in here. Same day delivery, huh? Oh yeah? Same day delivery, huh? Yeah. This! How do I get this shit back on? I forget. How do I get this back on? How do I put it back in? Oh no, I know. Look at how easy this is. Look at how easy this is to do. Check this out. Look at how easy this is. Done. Now you're ready to go. Good machine. Do a bowling ball. I can't do a bowling ball. It's not that type of vacuum. It's all over me. Okay. I can't do a bowling ball. That's not that kind of vacuum. It doesn't have that attachment. I don't. Why? This is music is still playing. Okay, we're good. I don't have that attachment. It's a stick vacuum. It's a stick vacuum. You can't do that.
Clean, defoam, deodorize, brighten, and lay down a layer of protection all at once, saving you time and money. You get professional results without being...
Dump your drink on the ground and clean it up.
I love the big green cleaner.
It's not a wet vacuum.
I clean pet stains fast before they ruin.
It's not a wet vacuum.
My kids love to make a mess in the kitchen. That's why I'm glad I've got the big green clean machine.
Replacing all these old-fashioned appliances, you'd expect the big green clean machine to cost well over $500. But now, the entire system can be yours for only $299. Or better yet, just 10 interest-free...
That's not how much I paid for mine!
$90 a month. You get Bissell's big green clean machine, the dry vacuum attachments, the washable...
That's not how much I paid for mine!
...extraction tools, the drain unclogger, the handy storage caddy, the carpet and upholstery and floor care formulas, the instruction guide, plus the step-by-step how-to video, and as a free bonus, Mary Ellen Pickham...
Anybody from Evolved is watching? Just Any vacuum cleaning shit I could do?
Wow, helpful hints that really work. Bissell's Big Green Clean Machine is not available in any store. Put it to your ultimate test for 30 days. If your carpets, upholstery, and floors aren't cleaner than they've ever been, return the Big Green Clean Machine for your money back.
I didn't borrow it. Iced coffee.
Challenge and order the Big Green Clean Machine right now.
To order for just 10 low monthly payments of $29.90, call
1-800-6900.
All right, here we go. Dump all that dirty water in there.
Commercial, we've dumped all the dirty water from these machines, and even with the few stains we picked up here in the studio, look at how dirty this water is, and that probably would have been left behind in your home.
And hey, Frank, get her husband back over here.
Thanks, too. And you know something else?
We're gonna see how long he can put his head under there for without puking.
And the Big Green Clean Machine is a must for pet owners. You can have all the dogs you want now.
Invite the neighbor's dogs over, sure.
And another thing, when our children are younger, we are sterilizing their baby bottles hours and hours and hours. And they're running around the house with a contaminated stuffed animal in their mouth, right?
That defeats the purpose, yeah.
But sometimes you can't launder these things, so...
I know I've seen a lot of people say a few things about you should do an infomercial thing. You're acting like I haven't made that call yet. You're acting like I haven't made that call?
Another great use for the Big Green Clean Machine.
I have.
Clean them up.
For the stuffed animal.
And another
I'm not saying a fucking single other thing about this.
Decorative pillows.
All right, you
okay,
can do this one?
Turn it on. And let's go. Clean up.
Stop!
Oh, wow.
My head.
It's all gone. Bed spreads are great too, and an occasional stain on your shirt.
That's a fucking $300 cashmere shirt you just ruined with your... Don't touch my shirt. I thought that was the same guy for a second. I had to take a double take. I thought that was the same person.
Thanks. Now, Eric promised he would show me how to unclog a drain. I'm going to run over here. Eric, how do we...
It was like, it's him again.
Okay, Joe. Now, remember, always use your Big Green Clean Machine first to unclog the drain. Never after you've tried chemical drain cleaners. Hit that powerful vacuum motor switch and let's see what happens. Okay. Now, I just put it right over here.
Put it right in there, Joe.
Okay, here we go. All right. We're coming up.
Did you... What the fuck?
It's great. It came right out.
You bet, Jill.
And come here. I'm going to show you what's worse than dust. It lives right here in your mattress. And they're called dust mites. And do you know there's 18,000 dust mites to a gram of dust?
Pretty disgusting.
That is really disgusting. But with the Big Green Clean Machine, goodbye to the dust mites.
Just pull them right out of there, huh?
Oh, come on. You had such an opportunity to go, no, no, help me, no. How, I really?
Kind of hung up right now.
He is indeed.
Unbelievable, they missed an opportunity.
All right, I'm going to finish this mattress. When's the last time you cleaned your mattress? It's easy to do with the Big Green Clean Machine, and it's a must if you've got a bedwetter, believe me. Joe, are you out there yet?
What?
Mary Ellen, you know, a lot of people spend time taking care of the outside of the
house. Who is she talking about?
Inside. Well, with a Big Green Clean Machine, you can deep clean that upholstery. Even the headliner, look, it came out great. And it smells good in here, too. All right, let me turn off the machine. Let's go over and check with Tom to see how he's doing in the dunk tank.
And let's open it up. As you see, we have a full 14-pound turkey inside of here cooking from all the vortex power.
All right, well, dunk away, because when we come back, we're going to keep checking in with Tom to see the final results of the dunk tank test. Also, we're going to let some audience members get their hands on a Big Green Clean Machine. All that and more when we come back. So don't go away here on Helpful Hands.
Introducing America.
All right, I think we're good to go on this one.
Machine.
You'd expect the Big Green structure to upholstery.
I think we got everything out of this one.
Recall 1-800.
Suck it up so easily.
Let some of our audience members try out the Big Green Clean Machine. Here's what's happening. How are the results?
Joe, this sheet of linoleum was covered in mud, dirt, and grime, and it sucked it up so easily. Look at this.
Pulls the dirt right up there. Wow. Beautiful. All right, I'm going to turn off that machine. How are we doing on a little chair here?
Hi, doing just great. I didn't know you could do your own light color upholstery. I always thought you had to have a professional.
All right, not in this case. Beautiful. I'm going to turn off your machine.
It'd be so loud in this room.
Oh, what was this stain you were working on?
That was grape juice, about the toughest you can get, and it's totally out.
Okay, grape juice, purple out of a green carpet.
Thank you, everyone.
It'd be so loud in here.
Well, Mary Ellen, I have to tell you, this is one example of what happens when the results speak for themselves. Congratulations.
Don't congratulate me. Thank the guys at Bissell. Take a bow, Eric.
Thanks, Mary Ellen.
Thanks, Eric.
All right, well, as far as we're concerned, the Big Green Clean Machine dunk tank test has been a success. Tom, thanks very much. You're high and dry. The test is over.
Wait a minute. How do we know there wasn't some trickery involved?
Yeah, let's see the trickery.
Wires holding that ball up. In the interest of science, no, I've just got to do it.
Don't, no, Mary Ellen.
I've got to do it. I do
it. No, don't. Oh no, he's I don't know if he made it. Why is everybody acting like he got like crushed by like a cinder block?
With a new helpful hint for the Big Green Clean Machine. I'm going to be extracting water out of Tom today. Right? Seriously, folks, the Big Green Clean Machine is going to keep all those valuables in your home valuable.
It was a pool of Bissell cleaner.
Buy the Big Green Clean Machine.
On behalf of Mary Ellen and Eric and Tom, this is Joe Farago saying bye-bye until we see you again next time on Helpful Hint.
I can't. I gotta. This fucking goddamn infomercials, man. I swear to God, why would they freeze on this? Why would you freeze on this? It's so weird. Why? Okay, we're gonna go to this one.
The following is a paid advertisement for the Express Ready Set Go, brought to you by GT Direct, Louisville, Colorado.
We don't have time in our busy lives to wait for food, so we fall into the fast food rut or buy carb-filled snacks.
It's Kathy Mitchell.
Millions have discovered the secret that fast food can be quick and...
My heart is fucking smoking right now.
All thanks to
it's Kathy Mitchell.
Express 101. What would you say if you could do even more? Like enjoying fresh,
oh my God, it's Kathy Mitchell.
Personal pizzas, fancy gourmet meals for two, as well as flaky personal.
I need to pause this because I want everyone to know. You have heard me say things on this stream over the last probably 4 or 5 years that came from this commercial. I've seen this probably 1,000 times. I have made weird references to this and never explained it. I just kind of copied her talking. And people might have just been like, what is he talking about? It's from this. It's from this. This 24 minutes has given me like 4 hours worth of stream content.
Pies in under 10 minutes. Now you can, thanks to the all-new Express Ready Set Go.
I'm not kidding. That's not a joke. I'm not kidding.
Pork tenderloin with sweet potato in 8 minutes. Grilled paninis in just 5 minutes.
Peak or a quick Kathy Mitchell, by the way.
With Spanish rice in
this
five
is
minutes.
The Infinity War of Kathy Mitchell infomercials.
This is possible thanks to breakthrough design advances, giving you 25% more.
I've said this before. If I saw Kathy Mitchell somewhere, like at like a fan meetup or a convention or something, I would actually be like, oh my fucking God. I don't give a shit about like, oh, what if you met like Brad Pitt? What if you met like, I can't even think of another celebrity. Who's another fucking celebrity? Is there any other celebrity I can think of? Brad Pitt. Give me anybody else. Any other name. Harrison Ford, yeah. No, it doesn't matter. I would be like, oh, hey, what's up, Harrison Ford? Nice to meet you. I don't care. Kathy Mitchell comes up and is like, hey, Kathy Mitchell here. I'd be like, hands are fucking sweating.
You don't overeat this
one. I'm not kidding. I'm not kidding.
You don't get any extra calories because you don't have to use a lot of oil or butter or anything like that.
She's incredible. She's incredible. She's so good in front of camera. She's so good at like taking a show, like, running a show and being like the quarterback of the set.
Television.
I'm not kidding. Seriously. You're not kidding. I'm not kidding. Reduce calories? Then let's go and join Kathy Mitchell, America's foremost cooking product expert, to see one of the most innovative ways to still enjoy quick, delicious, satisfying meals. Here she comes. The Express Ready, Set, Go.
Just like millions of you, the Express 101 is always there for me. And I can't imagine improving on what's already my most used kitchen helper. But I've heard improvement is exactly what's happened. And there's only one person in the world qualified to let us in on the news. So let's join my friend Kathy Mitchell and discover what's happened to the easiest cooking appliance in my home. Kathy, how are you?
Good to see you.
To see you too. I love my Express 101.
Well, I think you're going to love it even more now because look what we can do. Big, thick, man-sized sandwiches, beautiful frittatas, and quiches, full size. And look at these pies.
She actually said it.
Even cherry. You couldn't do that before.
You've improved on
man-sized.
I think we've made it even more perfect. Come on. Joe, this is the Express Ready, Set, Go.
Wow, Kathy, this is beautiful.
And it is ready. Look what we've done. We took out that center divider, so now you have 25% more cooking area.
So you can cook a lot of different things
exactly in here. Right, like about pizza. It makes the best pizza I've ever had. Now, this is my almost instant pizza dough, and the recipe comes with it. All you have to do is pop it in there and then put whatever toppings you like. It's a personal pizza, so you don't have to wait for the delivery man, pay extra for all the toppings.
No tip for the driver.
Exactly.
Why get delivery? You can make it in the Express Ready, Set, Go.
You'll never tell the difference, except it's not so greasy.
So we can
help you. You're saving a lot of calories. A little light mozzarella. Do you like peppers?
Sure.
Greasy.
Throw it out. Oh, more toppings.
Okay. That pizza's going to take 7 minutes, and we've got a built-in timer, so I just said it
only
for 7 minutes.
Only 7 minutes.
And it'll call me when the pizza's done. And the go part is, see the green light?
Uh-huh.
That green light comes on, you know your machine is preheated and ready to start cooking.
Ready, set, go. Wow, a lot of improvements here, Kathy.
7 minutes.
A lot of possibilities. Now, you don't always have to use pizza dough. Like, look here. These are corn tortillas. I'm going to make kind of a Mexican stacked pizza. And what I did was I just spread some beans on this corn tortilla, and we're going to just drop it right in there.
That easy.
It's perfectly.
Now I'm going to stack another one on top of that, and now we're just going to put on some meat. This is a great way to get rid of leftovers. So
yeah, like practical.
On there. And this one's only going to take about 5 minutes.
So that's practical shit.
I can set that timer for 5 minutes, and now I don't lose track of what's cooking. Have you ever had a Hawaiian pizza?
I know they exist.
Okay, this is pita bread, and it tastes almost exactly like pizza crust.
So you got a pita pizza.
Pita piza, that's right.
Now, I mean, I don't know about that.
All you have to do is add your toppings.
I don't know about that.
Okay, just smoosh it around
it
there.
Yeah, exactly. In this case, I'm going to use Canadian bacon.
Okay.
But like using leftovers and like kind of making new foods from like leftovers.
Sure, just scoop out a couple of chunks
on there. Yeah.
Okay.
You can have exactly what you want on it. And that's going to take, again, about only 5 minutes because the crust is basically already cooked.
This is all great, but I think all of us are really going to miss cooking those side-by-side meals you used to
cook. I know, like in the Express 101.
Let me show you something. Is this what you thought you were going to miss? This is the new insertable divider pan, and it goes in just like that.
Wow.
So they've got two machines.
And it's still the world's best no-fold omelet maker.
Love those omelets.
I do, too. This is just two beaten eggs, and I'm going to divide it between
Look
the ways
at that.
Just
We've
like
seen
this.
So many of this shit.
Guys,
We've
like
seen egg steamers,
omelets,
omelet
steak,
in the microwave.
Potatoes, a few
Take a look at that.
And on the other side, how about a veggie omelet? This is mushrooms and peppers and onions.
It's an omelet.
I'm going to just put a little cheese on top. And close that lid.
And neatness doesn't count. I remember you said that. Now that's going to rise
up.
It's going to rise up. And in 7 minutes, we're going to have a perfect omelet.
Cooking from top to bottom.
Now, how about a weekend breakfast? How about some stuffed French toast?
Oh, stuffed French toast? I've never heard of that one.
Oh, it's delicious. I bought this extra thick bread. I've spread it with a little cream cheese and some strawberry jam.
She knows what she's doing.
All I'm going to do is I'm going to go
ahead and use this man-sized French toast.
So just roll that sandwich in that egg batter. And in this case, now I'm using the entire cooking area of the machine. That's going to take about 5 minutes, so I just set the timer for 5 minutes. And how about some lunch?
I'm ready.
Okay, well, I'm gonna make you a grilled sandwich. So I've just got a nice piece of French bread here.
French
I'm gonna
bread.
Put on a little ham.
Ham looks good.
And some cheese and some tomatoes.
Yep.
And the top.
Ooh,
now,
I'm
gonna brush it with just a little bit of olive oil, which
not
is
anymore.
Very healthy for you.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll pop that right in there.
Hey, this is like a panini.
And that'll
you say?
In just about.
What'd you say?
And mm-hmm. we'll pop that.
What did Kathy Mitchell say?
And some tomatoes and the top. Now, I like to brush it with just a little bit of olive oil, which is very healthy for you.
By the way, I trust Kathy Mitchell more than, like, members of Congress. So, I mean, honest to fucking God, are you serious?
Mm-hmm. And we'll pop that right in there.
Hey, this is like a panini.
And that'll cook in just about 5 minutes, so we'll set that timer. And over here, I'm going to make two sandwiches at once, so
that's
I'm
not a high bar.
Now, you like wraps?
Yeah.
This is pastrami, so I'm going to put a little bit of mustard on it first. You can use pastrami? The different colored tortillas, the red and the green tortillas.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And I'm just going to lay that on there. Oh, okay, yeah.
That's good lean meat, too.
And some Swiss
cheese. I hope she's doing all right. Sure. You know what I mean? I hope she's like living a great life.
Pickles, right? All you do is fold in the sides and roll it up. Now, don't try to miniaturize.
Look, she's actually doing this too, by the way.
Room, and you got a nice deep cheese.
She ain't just putting like, oh yeah, like here's the thing that's already done. Like I pretended like I was gonna make it, but I didn't. Here, it's already done. Look, I pretended I made that. Look at this.
Pastrami.
Can't have pastrami without
pickles,
right?
She's actually making this sandwich.
All you do is fold in the sides and roll it up. Now, don't try to miniaturize the food, because this has got plenty of room, and you've got a nice deep well, top and bottom.
And it's got the hinged lid, so it'll raise
exactly.
up.
Exactly. Now, how about a corn dog?
Oh, I love corn dogs. It reminds me of being at the fair.
You're just a big kid. I know that.
I am.
Now, just like if I was cooking this in the oven, I'd spray
mustard
the pan.
Disappeared?
I'm going to spray okay. my... Just a big kid. I know. How about a corn
What are you talking
dog?
About? You know what she's talking about.
Plenty of pickles,
you don't know what she's
right?
talking about.
All you do is fold in the sides.
Where?
And roll it up.
It's right there.
Now, don't try to mix.
Are you trying to, hold on, we're trying to, like, smear in a way that's not going to work? Kathy Mitchell's fucking infomercial? It's not going to work. I just hate to tell you, that's not going to happen.
Because this has got plenty of room.
It's not going to happen.
And you've got a nice deep well, top and bottom.
And it's got the hinged lid, so it'll raise
exactly.
up.
Exactly. Now, how about a corn dog?
Oh, I love corn dogs. It reminds me of being at the fair.
You're just a big kid. I know that.
I am.
Now, just like if I was cooking this in the oven, I'd spray the pan. I'm going to spray...
It's there was the, what do you mean the mustard
no
disappeared?
Ever.
Now, mustard
when I
doesn't
make a corn
disappear.
Dog, personally, I put the whole hot dog in, but a friend of mine says they like it cut up because that way they get dog in every bite.
Look at how cool that is.
Like so
that.
You got the whole pack in there.
It all works just like that.
Did this wasn't like a recalled, right? Please don't ruin it for me. We've seen like four or five girls at this point. Like three of them got recalled. This one's all right, right? Express like 101. Express ready set go. Come on. It's a good product, I hope. Right? There's no really awful article about something horrible happening, right? I think so. This won awards. This thing won awards? All right. No recalls on this one. Nice. What are you fucking like? No, get out of here with this bullshit. It's got 4 stars on Amazon right now. Still on Amazon, it's got 4 stars. Yeah. Get out of here.
And close that lid. About 7 minutes.
All right, ready, set, go.
Ready, set, go. That's
it won Streamer of the Year.
Okay. Kathy, it smells like a pizzeria in here.
Oh, I know, but it doesn't cost like a pizzeria in here.
Listen
to
that
crunch.
These
pizzas cost about $1 each. Look at this, a perfect personal pizza
with exactly
what you want.
Pretty good, I'll be honest. I would eat that.
That's our Hawaiian with the Canadian bacon and a pineapple. And now how about our stacked pizza? Look at that.
Stacked pizza.
Now that's our tortillas with the
onions and
meat.
That's awesome.
Doesn't it smell great? I'm going to add on a little bit of lettuce and tomato.
Get this.
It was, no, it wasn't. You guys are just fucking haters, I think. You guys are trying to find anything you can on this. Come on. This looks fucking cool. This looks good. You're just haters. Are you just looking for anything, I think? Like, come on.
And my daughter made this up. These are crushed nacho chips, and it just gives it a little zing.
Fiesta.
Fiesta, exactly. Now, okay. Right on time.
Right on time.
Here's our pepperoni pizza. Now, this is your traditional
pepperoni
pizza.
All right, get the olives
pizza.
Off there.
And that dough smells so good. It's so fresh
wait
smelling.
Wait till you taste. Now, this is just, and can you hear how crisp it is?
I heard the crunch.
Listen to that crunch.
Are you classic Kathy Mitchell line.
I am, but it's going to be really hot.
I'm going to jump in and eat it.
He goes...
So fresh, so crisp, and so gooey on the top.
And
I
believe
love
it or
this.
Not, that's under 200 calories and only about $1. Sounds
like hold 200 on. Calories and that's under 200 calories. A slice? You mean the little thing he has in his hand?
About $1.
And eat it.
This thing is fucking 200 calories. That whole pizza is like 1,500 calories.
It's gonna be really hard.
I feel for this guy. This guy's great too, by the way. But like, he has to eat this. Like, he has to do that. You can't just like not eat it.
Jump
and in. If he takes even and 1 second where he's not biting this and not enjoying it, it looks bad. Product doesn't look good. This is probably molten lava in his mouth. And that's a champ, right? That is a champ.
So
are you kidding me? Without even, are they flinching?
Jump in and eat it.
And you can tell how fucking burning hot this is right there. It's like, this is like unbearable, but it's like, the show gotta go on.
Are you finally gonna feed me?
I am, but it's gonna be really hot.
I'm gonna jump in and eat it.
Yep.
So fresh, so crisp, and so gooey on the top.
Yep. And look, he's right back in.
That's under 200.
That's a real showman.
And only about a dollar.
That's
like
an actual showman
ready.
Right there.
You know, people love omelets, but a lot of people are afraid to make them. But look how easy they come out in here. Isn't that beautiful?
Beautiful.
No folding. And another thing you're going to love about the insertable divider pan is that it makes it a lot easier to serve.
Oh,
that's
two great, two great showmen.
Right out and onto the plate.
Two great.
That's our meat lover's omelet.
We got Kathy Mitchell.
Our vegetarian omelet. And look how they just come right out.
Virago.
No cleanup. That would just wipe out with a damp cloth. You know, it'll go in the dishwasher.
Legend.
It's wonderful.
More versatility for
Absolutely.
You there.
Absolutely. Okay, look, here's our French toast.
Stuffed French toast.
Exactly. And remember, I can utilize the whole base and the other side of the spatula that lifts the large.
That looks perfect.
And look at this. Now, wait till I cut into this. Remember, this has the stuffing of the cream cheese and the strawberries,
mm-hmm.
and it's hot.
He's gonna eat it. He's gonna go.
Oh, does that look delicious?
Yeah, he heard that and went. Breakfast,
and now
fuck,
lunch
not again.
Is ready. Now, you remember this was our grilled sandwich.
Look at that. Our panini.
Beautiful? Right. Now, I'm gonna use the large side of the spatula. And just lift that onto the gutting board.
See, this
and
is
I want you to
real.
See that it is just chock full of stuff.
Kathy Mitchell would not fuck with us.
So crisp and so delicious. All right, now look over here because here's our corn dog.
There it is. Look at all those little guys in there.
I'm
they popped
you,
right out.
You can have it
Looks
fast
good.
And easy just like that. And my kids like a little bit of mustard to dip it in
sure,
as they
sure.
eat it. And now this is our pastrami wrap.
Oh,
Let's
that the pastrami.
That and see what we got. Oh, look how full
I
that is. Doesn't that look delicious?
Look at that.
Oh, I want to bite
like
that
a
right
deli
now.
In here.
It
That's
does.
Wonderful.
Oh, I love a good wrap. Now, are you ready for some dinner?
I'm always ready for food.
All right, come on down here.
Oh, wait a minute. Now, you're going to put a
steak. No, Kathy, no.
Put my
Kathy, wait.
Go steak up against the finest restaurant and win.
Kathy. Those sandwiches were so good. And the...
All right, now, I'm just brushing with... Now, are you ready for some dinner?
What
I'm always
say?
Ready for food.
All right, come on down here.
Oh, wait a minute. Now, you're going to put a steak in this?
I would put my Ready, Set, Go steak up against the finest restaurant and win. All right, now I'm just brushing
God,
a little
I hope that
bit
would
of
be
steak
real.
Sauce,
mm-hmm.
and we're just gonna put it right in the machine.
Uh-huh.
And in
and
it goes.
The divider is out, so you have the full cooking area now.
Right,
you can
okay.
hear that sizzling.
Wow.
You like onions and mushrooms?
Sure,
I hear that sizzle.
So just cut up this mushroom and onion.
Okay.
Now let me turn this over. I wanna show you how much sear we've got already on that steak. Look at that.
So okay. this does heat up quickly.
Oh, it does. Now I'm just gonna go ahead and put in those mushrooms and onions. And that's going to cook to medium in about 7 to 8 minutes.
Seven minutes?
How about some unfried fried chicken? Fried chicken is so delicious and so much fat. I've got a skinless breast mm-hmm. and some legs, and I'm going to just roll them in some crushed up cereal crumbs. You can
cereal
use any
crumbs?
Kind of cereal you want. Just crush it up real fine.
Like
now,
Captain
the
Crunch?
Only oil I'm going to use for this chicken is a little nonstick spray.
No deep fat fryer, no warming the oven up.
No deep fat frying, exactly.
This probably
All
works.
Right in this. Look
and you know,
this.
Without that divider,
you
I've got.
You said you've got 25% more room.
Three big pieces of chicken in there.
There's three pieces of chicken in that
all
thing.
All these recipes are in the cookbook with times. That chicken is going to take about 10 to 12 minutes, depending on how big the pieces are.
Okay. But you guys, don't
right,
say anything
here,
yet.
I've got a full course meal.
And there's our divider.
And a side dish.
Guys, do you not trust Kathy Mitchell? I'm starting to see some like dissent here. Excuse me? You're not going to give her at least a minute to explain what's going on here? You don't trust her? You should trust her. I actually can't believe this. She had a ramen cookbook. I can't trust her. Are you serious? It's probably fantastic.
These are...
Kathy Mitchell would never lead us astray, ever.
Pork tenderloin medallions that I've marinated in a little teriyaki. Listen to that sizzle.
Listen to that.
Now, for a side dish for pork, I love sweet potatoes. So I've got some sweet potatoes and apple pieces mixed up together with a little bit of brown sugar. And that is going to cook in about 8 minutes.
All right.
It's not like cooking in the microwave where the food comes out rubbery. It's juicy, it's warm, and in fact, being able to cook with a little bit of oil is a good healthy habit for me and my kids.
Yeah, come on!
My husband watching our weight, trying to get healthy.
For the working person, very fast. Just frees you up from everything.
Look at that omelet!
Dishes, throw in the dishwasher, and you're done.
It's got a timer on it. It tells you when to put things in. It's quick, and when you finish, you don't have to clean it up. It's great.
This is the mini food pan, and it's probably my favorite because it'll just cook everything.
This
like, for instance, cinnamon rolls. I love to make cinnamon rolls in the morning for the kids, but who wants to heat up that big old oven?
Oh, not bad. Oven, get it away. Get it out of my house.
Minutes. So in here, I just spray it with a little nonstick. I cut each cinnamon rolls into three pieces, so now we're going to make cinny minis, and these only take 4 minutes. Remember, it's ready, set, 4 minutes to go. Okay. Now over here, I've got some little
ready,
smoky
set,
sizzling.
Go. Ready, set.
I'm gonna make some
4 minutes
in a
to
bracket.
Go.
My grandkids love these. And while I do this, if you could go back to the refrigerator and bring me a pan, you'll find in there.
Okay.
I've just got some pancake mix, and I'm gonna pour it right over those little smoky links.
I would
eat
these.
These are gonna make great finger food. I find that little kids really would rather eat with their fingers. Okay.
We don't have to. I don't have to be a little. You could be a fully grown man.
You know what I did? At night before I go to bed, I take a frozen tater tot, drop it into each well, and then pour some egg over it and put it in the refrigerator. Then all I have to do is get up, pop it into the ready, set, go, and I'll have eggsters or potatoes and eggs in
eggsters.
4 minutes. Ready, set, go. Okay, now, how about some meatballs? I know you like meatballs.
Oh, Grandma Farrago's favorite.
Farrago.
These
right.
I made special low-cal meatballs. These are ground turkey. Less than
oh, turkey.
It's my kind of recipe.
Wow,
form
healthy
into meatballs,
for you.
Absolutely, and pop them right in there. Now, these are going to cook without watching, without rolling, without turning in just about 8 minutes.
You don't have to deep fry.
When you taste them, you won't even hardly tell the difference.
Look,
now,
like you have a tiny
I've heard
arm.
You're a party animal.
Yeah, as long as it's before 8 o'clock.
Well, you know, hors d'oeuvres.
Look at that banter. I love the
what
banter.
I've got here are some crab stuffed mushrooms. All I do is mix up the stuffing and then top each one with a mushroom. So they're kind of upside down
stuffed
right
mushroom?
Now. But when they're done, we'll flip them over and we'll have hors d'oeuvres in about 4 minutes. It is so much fun.
4 minute hors d'oeuvres.
That's right.
All right. Ready, set, go.
Oh, I think that steak is ready. Are you ready for that challenge?
Yep.
All right. And let's take a look.
Oh, look at that.
Can you smell that? Oh, man.
Wow.
You said you'd put this steak up against any other steak?
I would
any
indeed.
Other way. The mushrooms.
You got to give that a taste.
Caramelized with the onions.
Can't just take her word for it.
I'm going to cut it right steak. Down the middle because I want you to see. Look at that. Oh. That's perfect. Medium steak. Now, if you like it a little more well done, you could leave it in a little bit longer. I'm just catch a little. Now, it's going to be hot.
Okay.
Oh, no.
Be careful. Yeah, but it's worth it.
It's as good as a restaurant steak, is it not?
Kathy,
perfectly
you met the challenge.
Good.
Kathy.
Excellent. Excellent steak.
All right. Now, how about some chicken?
There's
and
the chicken.
Look at that.
Fantastic.
That was medium.
Unfried,
it was.
Fried
unfried
chicken.
Fried chicken. That's cut the fat way down.
That's a good
steak. Guys, Kathy Mitchell.
Dinner, isn't it?
That's
Kathy Mitchell got famous and popular. She became a huge streamer from this. She got really popular. Well, she played a lot of Among Us. But besides that, she was in like the Minecraft stuff for a while. But she is known for doing kind of like out of the box recipes. So she would like I know people are like what the ew gross like cereal. No, it's like she's like imitating recipes. She did like recipe imitations, like leftover recipes. She's not making fried chicken. She's doing. It's like her thing, right? Why is everybody minus twoing me? What? I'm telling you what's going on here. The Among Us joke? Okay.
Beautiful.
Okay.
Now over here, this was the pork. And again, I love the
fact right. I said the words Among Us. I forgot. That's an automatic minus two from everybody.
Can take this out because it makes it so much easier to serve. I'm just going to put out that pork, and let's get those potatoes out. Those are sweet potatoes. Oh, they look delicious, don't they? You want a little taste? Isn't that delicious?
It's the most delicious program I've ever worked on.
All right, I want to show you a couple of ideas.
That was kind of weird.
This is an idea you're going to love. This is my leftover box. Leftovers
What's
make great
in there?
Pizzas. I'm going to make you a white pizza. Mm. For a white pizza, I'm just going to use a little ranch dressing. Just kind of.
See, she's
now,
like the left. She does leftover
see
stuff.
What needs to get used up. Here's some broccoli. This may be the only
broccoli,
way you can get broccoli
ranch.
In your kids. I've got some shredded chicken here. Let's add that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and a little bit of mozzarella cheese.
What?
Getting rid of these leftovers. Think of the money I'm saving.
Well, you guys are so above this somehow. Why?
It's from pizza. All right. Oop, sounds like our minis
That's
are ready.
That's probably going to be fine.
All right, now this was City Mini.
Why is everybody so above that? That's where he's good.
Aren't these cute?
Those are great.
Right?
Perfect.
Now, these are our little pigs in a blanket. And I want you to see, because that's the pancake mix.
We use seasoning.
It's just a little spoon at the bottom of each one.
Look at that little
dog
in there.
And you put them out on the plate. And
that chicken was probably already seasoned. It's leftover chicken. That was leftover chicken, leftover broccoli. It's probably already ready to go. You just have to heat it up. What do you mean, seasoned? It's been seasoned already. It's leftovers.
The kids just dip them right in the syrup and eat them with their fingers.
What a
it's just a great
breakfast
for kids. These are the eggsters.
Right, the ones I brought from the fridge.
Right. We can just dump these right out onto the plate.
Okay.
Those are just little taters with the omelet around them. Kids love them. And this, because it comes out, will go right in the dishwasher. No cleanup at all.
I love
now,
the ding.
All right, this is... not your grandmother's meatballs.
This I've got to try.
All right. Now, I'm going to give you a tiny little bite of one of them. Okay. Just that's kind of cheating. And I'm going to put
so
some
hot.
On
this
my
guy.
Spaghetti.
I feel so bad about this guy.
Is that good? And remember, that's turkey.
So it's almost a health
so
food.
So, you know, you make those meatballs up ahead of time when you get home.
Here, it's going to be burning hot. Here, take this. It's hot.
Now, over here, this
eat this pizza.
Stuff,
it's burning.
Right.
I feel bad for this guy.
Stuffed mushrooms. And again, because I can remove that insert, I can just put my plate right on there. And flip it over, and look at that.
Wow.
That goes back in there because, you know, if you're having a party, there's nothing worse than cold, hot hors d'oeuvres. So we can just...
Seriously.
You know, Kathy, this is absolutely remarkable, but have you been holding
something
back
from me, like dessert?
Well, I have some very special desserts. Come on over here, and I'll show you. This first one I've got, it's kind of a giant cookie pizza.
I call it a cookie-tza.
Your favorite cookie dough. This happens to be oatmeal chocolate chip. Anytime you need a quick dessert, pop it right in just like this.
Look at that, a cookie-tza right into the well.
Right in the well in 4 minutes.
Oh.
Now, I know you love chocolate.
Mm-hmm.
I heard this is your dad's favorite.
Dad loves this one and he's got those little candy bars around
all right,
the house.
Candy bar filled cakes. There is a recipe that tells you how to take a box cake mix and split it into thirds. So you just fill the well. And now in this side, I'm just going
to
put a little candy bar treat.
Now,
this is really going to be a mystery dessert because I have no idea what flavor this is. Into that same chocolate cake, I've got coconut macaroons right down the middle. So we're going to close the lid.
You don't know what's in there?
Set the timer for 7 minutes.
Two different kinds of desserts?
Now,
fantastic.
Come on over here because I got something really special to show you. There's lots of different insert pans that'll go in here. This happens to be the full round insertable. And I like this because I use it for my world famous... upside down cake.
Uh-huh.
So in the bottom, I've got some butter and some brown sugar.
These gross.
And I'm just going to put three pineapple
people keep making
rings.
Them in infomercials, and I
three to six people.
Never had it.
Depending on who those people are. Okay, so I have the pineapple rings and a little cherry in the middle of each one.
I feel like
and
I would
this
like
is just
this.
A yellow
Am I like weird enough
mix.
To like this?
So you just fill it, pop it in there, and that's going to bake for
They're good. It's good.
7 minutes.
They're pretty good.
And you didn't have to heat up the whole oven.
And that's going
to
save you a lot of money on energy.
It's
Oop,
good.
I think
love
our
pineapple
makeover is done.
It was always seen as like
okay.
the jokey meme cake from like the 90s.
And
there's our white pizza.
It was such a meme that I didn't
now
want
remember,
to try it.
We made this with leftovers, things you normally would have just thrown out. So it's really good for the budget. And wait until you taste it.
All you guys were talking shit about this. If this was here right now in front of me, I would eat this right now and I would probably love it. Everyone was talking all this shit. I would eat this. It's just chicken, broccoli with like a nice, like crispy crust, the cheese, some ranch. Like, that's fine. I think it would be good. What's wrong with that? What do you mean raw?
Can you hear how crunchy that is? Yeah, I know you want to taste
yeah,
this.
Yeah, I am kind of a pizza fan.
Give that a try. Is that good?
You know, this does not taste like leftovers. It tastes like a freshly cooked meal.
So you're loving the Express Ready, Set, Go now as much as I do?
I am, and I'm going to have another bite of pizza.
Okay.
The Express Ready, Set, Go.
I want it so bad.
This unique cook rolled in 5 minutes. Delicious. And wait, we'll deduct.
All right, we'll see the end.
Good tasting food.
Dude, 20 minutes just blazed by so fast. I love it. I love Kathy Mitchell's so much. That time just disintegrated.
Save time, money, and calories.
Pizzeria quality pizza right here in just minutes. It's a pizza maker, it's a panini maker, a perfect omelet maker, and it's even a dessert maker, which I can't wait to try.
And don't forget the new accessories, the insertable divider pan for
Watch
cooking
the
two
ramen
meals at
commercial,
one time,
I will.
And the fantastic mini food pan, which certainly puts the fun back in cooking.
I am impressed with the controlled cooking chamber that cooks foods from the bottom and the top, and it lets me fry and bake and grill all with one appliance while saving me time, saving me money, and
Hulk Hogan
saving
versus
energy.
Kathy Mitchell.
That's almost 70% savings in energy.
Hulk Hogan versus Kathy Mitchell grill. I'm laughing about what you said.
energy costs. And you know the cookbook gives you simple, step-by-step instructions, and most are made in under 10 minutes.
Finally, dessert.
Okay. All right, we get to see it.
Well, are you ready for the family cookie?
I am so cookie-tza? Ready. The cookie-tza.
All right, now this is one.
There's the cookie-tza.
Cookie. Just make one. But if you have a cookie. Favorite cookie recipe, you can use it. Now, do you like yours a la mode?
Of course.
Oh yeah. Nice big pile of ice cream in the middle. All right, now here's your dad's favorite
that
cake.
That looks familiar.
All right. Get that guy
your
out here.
Dad's favorite cake.
Now, this was the Joyous Almond Cake, remember?
Oh, yeah, with the macaroons in the center. That really is beautiful the way
beautiful?
It came up.
Now, let's see.
Oh, yeah.
We're going to solve the mystery of what's in the mystery cake. Oh, I think that was some caramel.
Yep, great. And finally, and the piece de resistance.
Yes, the pineapple upside down cake.
All right, what is it? Let's see it.
All right, so we're just going to turn that upside down and flip it
Presto
over.
Presto flippo.
You know, I usually leave one piece of pineapple behind. Oh!
Look at that. That is a piece of artwork. That's a beauty, isn't it? Fast food can be fantastic food thanks to the Express Ready Set.
Bro, this looks like gas station food. So what? What's wrong with gas station? Some gas stations do pretty good shit. What are you talking about? Ban that guy. All right, give me the link to the ramen thing. Let me take a look. We got another Kathy Mitchell here. Where is it? Hold on, let me. This one here? Is this the right one? Okay, this is called Ramen Joy? Is this the right one? This is the right one, right?
Eyes on these homemade dishes and chocolatey desserts, all made with ramen noodles.
Really? Ramen noodles?
Right.
Yes, ramen. Hi, Kathy Mitchell here with my new Ramen Joy cookbook, filled with unbelievable recipes everyone will love. This entire basket cost under $10, and wait till you see what you can make with it.
Check I trust her.
Out. Ramen shrimp. Ramen tacos, even ramen sliders. Watch this. Brown some beef or any other meat with a ramen seasoning pack. Dump in a package of ramen, a good-sized squirt of ketchup, and a can of cola. Yes, cola. For a fantastic barbecue beef pasta better than what they serve at the rib joint at a fraction of the cost. Want more? Form cooked ramen and egg into a fast pizza crust. Then add your favorite toppings. For
trust
a
her.
Mouth-watering pizza
I trust
in
her.
Minutes. It's right here on page 84.
I trust
and here's
her.
My favorite. Just dump some ramen on top of some leftover chicken and veggies. Add a can of soup.
I trust her.
Stir and bake. A delicious feast for the whole family, all for less than $3. You're going
like this.
What the best salad.
Thanks, Kathy. I trust you. It's good. You're the best. Oh, why don't you take another bite? No. Yeah. Yeah, of course I will. That one was so easy to get down. Delicious.
Lettuce, onions, and mandarin oranges. Top with crushed ramen and pecans, and use your seasoning pack to make an awesome dressing.
It's probably fine.
Bestseller, you can
relax.
Easily make at home. Oh, love that crunch. How about these decadent truffles or grandma's ramen apple pie?
Ramen apple pie?
I love these recipes. I made the cranberry crumble. It was fast, easy, and so delicious.
I trust her. I don't care. I would eat all this.
With my new Ramen Joy cookbook. Just
I would eat all this just to make sure. That she was, like, happy. You know what I mean? I would eat this and be like, yeah, no, it was all right. It was good. Just because I know that might make her, like, happy. You know what I mean? That might make her, like, she'd be like, oh, cool. He liked it. What?
Get ramen nibbles with my favorite party recipe.
What? You would be a great poison tester.
Like these cheesy jalapeno poppers or this fresh ramen hummus. And don't forget dessert, chocolate mousse-filled ramen cups. Yummy. You can get both books with nearly 100
a joke,
delicious
though?
Ramen recipes for $10.
It could be a joke.
Here's how to order.
Call 1-800-383-7650
to get Ramen Joy on the special. It's just for fun. It's probably just, it's probably fucking just for fun.
www.byramenjoy.com. So call.
It's just a, like a fun thing to do with like ramen. Whatever. It's probably fine. It's probably tastes good. I'm telling you right now, I trust Kathy Mitchell, so I don't care. No, I don't care. If Kathy Mitchell is doing it, I support it. Sorry. Sorry. All right, what else we got? I got a little bit more time. Let's do some of the quick ones. How about the handy peel? I got it already here.
Are you tired of peel, peel, peel?
This is Stir's sub sound, isn't it?
Are you tired of peel, peel, peeling potatoes? Stop! Introducing Handy Peel, the quick and easy way to prepare a meal. Pick a raw potato, hold under the water.
Wasn't this his sub sound?
Peel and scrub all at the same time.
It is. A pile of perfectly or was for a while. Potatoes.
It's that easy. The secret is the Handy Peel's molded rubbing nubs that grip and cleanly peel the skin. Old-fashioned peeling is hard and wasteful.
That actually might be all right.
Just rub, peel, and scrub. Just look at the difference. Now you can prepare a pile of potatoes in no time for mounds of mouth-watering creamy mashed or fabulous homemade French fries.
You don't think it'll work?
Cooked to perfection. Sweet potatoes are really hard to peel with a knife. Ouch, that hurts. Not with Handy Peel. Simply rub, rinse, and peel all at the same time.
Plumbing gloves.
For delicious whipped sweet
potatoes.
They don't
work.
With Handy Peel, you can prepare tasty homemade chips in no time.
All right, so it don't work. It don't work.
Types of potatoes. Handy Peel is
aroma trim?
Well, we took both Crave Ender and Suppress to the 3rd Street Promenade in Santa Monica, California, where there's over 45 great restaurants in a 3-block area. First, we tested Crave Ender. Boy, are these folks in for a surprise. Watch this.
What is this?
Now you have chocolate. I want another piece, and I'll put it down, knowing I shouldn't have any more, but I'll go get more.
It's a good brownie, yeah? Mm. Okay, wait, hang on.
What?
Now, do you think there's a product that could help you not eat that brownie anymore? Would that be amazing?
That would be more than amazing. That would be a lifesaver.
It's a good brownie, though. What's wrong?
It's changing the taste.
What?
Do you want to finish the brownie?
No, I really don't want to.
Are you serious?
What does it smell like?
I really don't want it because it's changing the taste.
What does it smell like?
It is definitely changing the taste.
So you could tell, you're going to tell me you don't want that brownie anymore?
I really don't want it.
Wait, you just,
this is chocolate. I have no taste for another piece.
Eat it. That's kind of sad. This lady loves brownies. This lady loved brownies, and we just ruined it for her. She, like, hates them now. She's treating the brownie like cigarettes. That's kind of fucked up.
And how do you feel then?
I'm shaking because I'm excited. I feel fabulous. I do not desire another piece of chocolate. This is wonderful. Oh, world, listen to this. This is fabulous.
Take a little bite.
What?
Mmm, it's good.
Mmm, delicious cookie.
You could probably eat that entire cookie, couldn't you?
Oh, yeah.
Not a problem. No.
What is it? What is it?
Three or four of them.
Smell this thing. Now you don't like things you like.
All you have to do is just smell it, and you won't want that cookie.
Not really.
Keep chewing. Keep enjoying that cookie that you love so much. You can eat three or four of those.
It's all right.
I couldn't even possibly eat this anymore.
Somebody said there's a little piece of dog shit in the container. That's fucked up.
Are you serious?
I'm really serious.
You just told me three or four.
Here, smell this dog shit.
Honestly, on a normal
do you want to eat anymore? No, actually, I don't want to eat anything. I just smelled dog shit. I think I would. Hey, when was the last time any of you stepped in dog shit? When was the last time? You know, everyone talks about, like, the joke is like, oh man, oh, don't step in dog shit. When was the last time you ever stepped in dog shit? I don't think it's ever happened. Like, have you ever stepped in fucking dog shit? And people talk about that's like it happens. I don't think it ever happens to anybody. It happened to me a few days ago. Yeah, I feel like it's been like 10 years since I've stepped in a pile of dog shit.
I never am able to stick with the diet. This I could stick with, definitely. I like this stuff, it's good.
Because this is making it taste differently.
Like wow.
It's like an herbal smell.
Definitely took away my desire for the sweet.
Is that amazing?
Amazing. Yes, amazing.
You could eat this whole thing. Yeah. If I gave it to you, you could consume the entire thing.
That whole thing.
That whole thing?
That whole thing.
All right.
Take a French
fry. And eat it. Keep it on your...
But listen. Keep it on your nose. Who is... Okay, if I order a thing of French fries... Okay, I go to the counter and I order French fries. Okay, please, thanks for the French fries. I bought that, I'm going to eat it. I'm not going to buy French fries, take a bite of the French fries and smell this thing and then throw the French fries away. That's weird, right? If you already buy the thing, if you bought the brownie, you're going to have inside of your head a fight here where it's like, I just bought this brownie. I want to eat the brownie. Why did I buy the brownie? No, I'm going to eat the brownie. It's not going to be like, oh, bought the brownie. Thank you. Here's like the $2.50. Thank you. $3, whatever, for the brownie. Mmm. Throw it away. What? People are going to eat it.
Tons of French fries.
You don't want anymore?
Want this. No.
Are you sure?
No, I don't want anymore. Well, if I had this in my face with... I don't think I'd want any French fries. I know that would kill half of my diet there.
I want this guy to like enjoy those French fries, don't you? That's like, I don't know, that's like kind of sad. I wonder how long it lasts, yeah. Instant alarm?
Every day, you live with the risk of someone breaking into your home, or a child getting into harmful chemicals,
whoa!
Or even falling down a stairway.
Hi, Anthony Sullivan here for the new Instant Alarm System. It'll make your home safer for you and your family. It installs in seconds with no tools and no wires. As soon as the door is opened, the alarm goes off.
Okay,
use the wireless Instant Alarm on every window in the house. As soon as it's opened, you'll be alerted. It can help safeguard young children by alerting you when they get into places that they don't belong. Use it on sliding doors. As soon as the magnetic seal is broken, the alarm goes off. If you have a swimming pool, the wireless instant alarm is great. It lets you know where your children are going. And they add extra security for people who live alone and the elderly.
It's practical. No, that's practical. This is actually this has a good use. That's practical. Like an alarm, like a window alarm. Like this, what? This, come on. This is practical uses for this.
There's even a chime feature that's great for use as a doorbell for a home or a business. Just peel off the backing, stick them on, and it's an easy way to add security and get peace.
I mean, I wouldn't want that to be my doorbell,
but... Here's how the instant alarm works. When the magnetic field between each unit is broken, the alarm goes off. So even if somebody breaks a window with a wireless instant alarm, the 90 decibel alarm will go off, and for all an intruder knows, the police are on the way. The wireless instant alarm lets you worry less and provides more security for your entire family.
How do you remove it?
It really gives me peace of mind to know the instant alarm.
I don't know, maybe it's like a little
security on my doors and windows,
hack or something?
As well as monitoring my kids.
Looks like Velcro or a tack.
Security system.
Call now and you'll get 4 instant alarms complete with batteries for just $10. But that's not all. Order today.
I'm sure it has an off
we'll
option.
Give you
yeah.
A second set of 4 free. Just pay separate shipping and handling. That's right. You'll get a total of 8 deluxe wireless instant alarms complete with batteries for just $10.
Why is he in a bathroom? He's like recorded. Why is he like in a this weird echo?
That's right. You'll get a total of 8 deluxe wireless instant alarms complete with batteries for just $10. So call the number
on the bottom of your screen. Yeah, he's in this
right
house.
Now. Here's how to order.
He's in like a big house. Okay. He's in a big house. Perfect patty. Smart spin.
It's a celebration. Over 8 million people have made SmartSpin America's best-selling TV advertised storage system. And to say thank you, we're giving
just
away
storage.
$1 million worth.
Details the easy smoker?
Bulk-
no smoking here, no smoking there.
These days, you can't smoke anywhere. Until now. Introducing the Easy Smoker Electronic Cigarette. An all-new easy alternative to smoking cigarettes.
What?
That you can smoke virtually anywhere. Without the flame, ash, tar, or carbon monoxide found in traditional cigarettes. Because
why would you want it to look like that?
No smoke. Here's how it works.
Why would you want it? People are going to come up to you.
Parts.
You're going to get confronted. This is like a prank. Wouldn't you want it to not? You are pretending to smoke a real cigarette in a restaurant. You're trying to call attention to the fact that you are doing this. It's like that guy's smoking a cigarette over there. I'm looking at the. We got to go up and talk to that person. I mean.
Easy Smoker consists
why would you want it to look like
parts,
that?
The lithium ion battery and the cartridge. As you inhale, airflow is detected by a sensor.
Oh, this is the technology. You hear the fucking cigarette technology?
Airflow is detected by a sensor, which activates a heating element and vaporizes the solution inside the cartridge. It produces a smoke-like odorless vapor that's not really smoke. And without any of the over 4,000 toxins found in traditional tobaccos, 4,000.
Why they key this guy in here? This guy's keyed into this like office, I guess. Why can't you just do this in a room?
It's not really smoke. And without any of the over 4,000 toxins found in traditional tobacco cigarettes, the tip even glows for a more realistic smoking experience, and automatically shuts itself off when not in use.
Oh my fucking god!
You can smoke it virtual. It automatically shuts itself off when not in use. The best part is you can smoke it virtually anywhere. In your home, at the office, even at a restaurant or bar. No more having to stand outside every time you want to smoke. And no more dangerous.
That's such a bad habit. Like, come on.
You know, it's so great. I can even smoke in the office now. And my hair and clothes don't smell anymore.
I don't have to go outside to smoke. And it saves me money.
Easy Smoker has sold for over $150.
They're like falling asleep.
But we're so sure it's going to make a difference in
this
your life.
This motherfucker's on an airplane.
We'll send it to you.
Again, he is not sitting on an airplane. He is keyed into an airplane picture.
We're sure it's going to make a difference in your life that we'll send it to you absolutely free. Just pay shipping and processing.
Huh?
Your free Easy Smoker comes with a membership in our Easy Smoker Club.
Oh, no.
So you can get refill cartridges at a special discounted price. Easy Smoker is available in regular and menthol. So, if you're going to smoke, smoke easy. Here's how to get yours.
Oh, my God. That's wild. That's fucking wild. How much was it? $150? It's $150. How much is a joule? 10-second Kathy Mitchell smoothie maker. Yep.
Stay tuned as Kathy Mitchell introduces her amazing twist and flip 10-second smoothie maker.
Hi, I'm Kathy Mitchell with my amazing smoothie maker. Just fill the cup with whatever you like. Strawberries, bananas, even low-fat yogurt. Then just twist on, flip it, and watch. In seconds, the reverse turbo action turns your favorite fruits or veggies into a smoothie.
What?
Fast,
reverse
fresh,
turbo
and
action?
Your own it's smoothie. Watch. Flip it and watch. In seconds, the reverse turbo action.
What is it? But it's a blade. That doesn't do anything. Going like turning it upside down doesn't. It just turns the blender on. That doesn't do anything.
Turns your favorite fruits
who cares?
And veggies into a smoothie.
What's the
fast, fresh, and
I feel like
right
half of this machine doesn't have to exist.
Pennies. Mmm, and delicious. Plus, it virtually cleans itself with this cleaning cup and just water. Ready for the next smoothie.
The ball?
Look, the blade
sitting
is
on the countertop.
Now everyone gets exactly what they want.
Is
like
the
cookies
product.
And cream for my grandkids.
But and it takes up easy. Such less counter space. Why
now
do you have this thing?
Everybody's happy.
The unique emulsifying disc blade design's reverse action technology creates a turbo funnel that sends
holy
everything
shit.
Disc blade design.
Boys and girls, that was a mouthful. That was a true technology mouthful. What was that again?
Oh, everybody's happy.
The unique emulsifying disc blade design's reverse action technology.
Holy shit. Hold on. I gotta write this down.
The unique.
The what? What was it? The unique? Uh I gotta get this written down. Unique. It's gotta be like red. That was a lot. That was an insane amount of info. Okay, unique.
Unique emulsifying.
Unique emulsifying.
Disc blade design.
Disc blade design.
Designs reverse action tech.
Reverse action technology. That's a lot. Unique emulsifying display design reverse action technology.
Technology
Jesus.
Creates
make
a
that the stream title.
Turbo that sends everything into the vortex, creating a perfect smoothie every time.
Every smoothie maker Word comes with my recipe guide, including this recipe for Orange Genius. A little milk and ice, one orange, and a spoonful of the secret powder that's probably already in your kitchen.
What's the secret powder?
Just like at the fair. Stop with the lots of bucks frozen coffee orders. Now you can make the most delicious cold coffee combos for pennies. And with a sip lid,
they got a little
it's
lid.
It's ready to go. And that's
it's a secret
money
powder.
In your
what is
pocket.
It?
For safety, this blade will absolutely not turn on until the cup is locked into position. What?
Safety, they're thinking
Super
about safety.
Strawberry slush. Veggie feel great with eight. Frozen
no, you're not gonna do more than three.
Eight.
No, no, more, no more than four. No, more than five.
Madness. Not only are they scrumptious, but you're getting 100% of the vitamins and dietary fiber, including the pulp. Not just a glass of juice, a smoothie that no one can resist, especially me. That's delicious.
I trust
the
her.
Number on your screen now to order Kathy Mitchell's smoothie maker
bill?
In white or...
All right, we'll do a couple more. Just like one or two more. Pasta boat. I don't know. There's so many. There's so many. Grab a bite, Kitty Liddy, the Ruggies, the Dog Dicer, Toilet Tunes. Is this TOS? Is this TOS? Is this, I'm not gonna be people like pissing, right?
I'll be right back.
Is this TOS?
Ooh, dry skin.
Are you okay in there?
Fine.
That's not what happened. That's not what happened. I was testing to see, make sure it was friendly for Twitch. It was... Okay, fuck this one. I'm out of here. How about the Easy Yolk? The Easy Yolk sounds good.
Egg whites have only 15 calories, are high in protein, and are virtually fat and cholesterol-free. But separating the egg yolk from the white is a real pain. Until now, introducing Easy Yolk, the world's egg yolk separator. Easy Yolk separates the yolk in seconds, directly from the frying pan.
What do you do with
without
it?
Without leaving behind a big mess. We all know egg whites are healthier, but are they worth the hassle?
No, fuck with this Easy propaganda. Fuck this propaganda. I'm taking a stand right now. Egg yolks are good for you. This is what all the vitamins, all the fucking fats. Oh, but Jeremy, there's cholesterol. Oh my fucking God, that's where everything is. Yolks are where all the good shit is. Oh no, cholesterol! Oh no! Shut up! Shut up! Everybody talk. Eggs are good. Eat eggs. They're good. Just don't eat a fucking 100 of them. Don't eat 100 eggs a week. Don't eat the egg shit. Don't eat the yolks. Only eat the egg whites. No, man, that's where all the good stuff is in the yolk.
Pancakes and waffles, omelets and souffles, French toast and homemade muffins, even breakfast burritos can all be made with egg whites. And if you like to bake...
And look, I understand, egg whites are great. If you want to do like an egg white omelet, somebody said egg white omelets are good. Yeah, they are. If you want to have an egg white omelet, But like, people that like, oh no, take the yolk and fucking throw it away. No, no. Why get rid of it? If you want to specifically have like, oh, you know, today I feel like I want to feel like a little lighter. I'm gonna do an egg white omelet. All right, cool. I'm sure it's delicious. It is. The super frog sound effects.
You'll
in here.
Love easy yolk. It's easy to master meringues or heavenly angel food cake. You'll wonder how you ever lived what? Without the easy yolk. Watch us separate the yolks with easy yolk while only one yolk is removed. That's the old-fashioned way.
That is super frog.
The Easy Yolk's patent-pending design pulls egg yolks quickly and easily. With one squeeze, the egg yolk is sucked up the perfectly sized sleeve and
look,
deposited into the bowl.
Okay, listen. I know that there are a lot of people that have dietary restrictions. Maybe you do have really high cholesterol and you need to take it down. I get it. But if you just have a regular diet and that you're like a healthy individual and you're not trying to like go on a diet or anything, the yolk is fine. This did not get stopped. All right, one more, and then I gotta go. So we ended on dump cakes.
You love delicious homemade desserts, but recipes can be complicated and take so long to make. Hi, Kathy Mitchell here with my new dump cake cookbook. Forget measuring. Now you can easily make homemade desserts in minutes. It's as simple as dump
ad.
And bake for delicious desserts every time. Guaranteed.
I don't even care.
Watch this. Start with fruit, dump on your favorite cake mix, and finish with a can of soda. Or you can use diet for a guilt-free dessert. Then just bake it in the oven for a delicious raisin peach dump cake. Oh, so scrumptious.
What's wrong with this?
Look, your kids will devour this s'mores chocolate cake.
I want that right now, Kathy.
Here's the cake mix.
Kathy.
Just dump on the good stuff.
Kathy, are you going to feed me, Kathy?
Even chocolate cookies. Bake and voila.
That looks good.
Best dessert ever. Now, here's one of my favorites. Just dump syrup, sugar, cinnamon, and nuts in a pan, and then just layer in some biscuits for fresh, warm, sticky buns. Just like Grandma used to make.
Eh.
It really is mistake-proof. You just dump and bake. I never knew homemade desserts could be this easy.
You don't need to spend hours to make homemade cakes. Get my dump cake
cookbook today.
Wait,
that kid just hit. The kid just
all
like
the carbs,
punched mom.
All the calories make you wince when you pinch an inch. Now lose the carbs and help twist the calories away with the Skinny Gourmet, the new food prep miracle that twists fresh vegetables into healthy pasta dishes. Watch how easy. Just insert a zucchini and twist. Presto! In seconds, you'll
we
have
already saw that
of
one.
Low-carb noodles. Now add marinara sauce.
One more. This is it. Last one.
This is KNN, the Kids News Network.
Good morning. I'm Chucky Stewart. Today's top story, is this the end of the sandwich as we know it? Most of us expect a sandwich to be plain, square, possibly with the crust cut off.
Mm-hmm.
But Susie Brady reports that this is changing.
Thanks, Chucky. I'm here outside Swatson Elementary, where a new trend is invading lunchboxes. They're called sandwich shapers.
Is this a school
cutting
project?
Cutting devices to let moms and kids cut their usual sandwiches into some very unusual shapes. Like this spiral, this fish, or even this rabbit in a hat.
Brian is so finicky.
Wait a minute.
But when I started using sandwich shapers, well, you can see how he gobbles it right up.
Brian's mom was the first to try sandwich shapers, but it wasn't long before every kid at Swatson was begging for these new lunchtime treats.
Oh, look, I got the butterfly. Pretty.
I got the donut. Awesome.
But not everyone's thrilled with the change.
It's hard on the kids who can't get these sandwich shapers. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to get back to my lunch. A bear? Cool!
What, I feel like that's like gonna be fucking me in 30 years.
Back to you, Chucky.
Excuse me, I have to get sandwich shapers. It's hard.
But not everyone's thrilled with the change.
It's hard on the kids who can't get these sandwich shapers. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to get back to my lunch. A bear? Cool!
Back to you, Chucky.
Hope that guy's doing good.
Thanks, Susie. And we'll have more after this commercial break.
Sandwich shapers
sandwich
are a cool
shapers.
New way to turn ordinary sandwiches into extraordinary lunchtime treats. Pull a rabbit out of a hat, then eat them both. Let your butterfly fly free before
I mean,
it ends up in your stomach.
Cool.
Or just have fun with a PB&J. You get to eat the donut and the hole. Hate the crust? No problem. With sandwich shapers, mom.
I mean, I would say
you can remove them quick.
I mean, if you're only gonna eat this one like big part of the sandwich, that's kind of it's just a tiny sandwich.
quick and easy. And with our special sandwich boards, they slide straight.
I think, like, okay, you eat this whole thing and there's a cool imprint, right?
Into the bag. No touching. No mess. There are 9 sandwich shapers to choose from.
Yeah.
When you buy these 3 for $10.99, you get 3 more.
I mean, if you're only going to eat the bunny rabbit part, that's... I mean, at what point is it like, I'm going to make a sandwich and throw half it away so I can have the bunny shape? Anything you'd want to, like, slowly introduce to the kids? Like, hey, like, we're going to start to eat, is that like a sandwich? No, you're just gonna eat the bunny ears? And not like throw half the sandwich away?
It's a bonus. Just pay separate processing.
That's a waste, right?
Its own sandwich board free.
Apparently, here's how you order.
It's $11. Alright, one more. Whatever we get. Okay, whatever we get. We're gonna let the algorithm take it. Whatever it is. The perfect pie cutter.
Of serving your pie like this? You bake the perfect pie, but it crumbles apart when you serve it. You carefully cut your pie, but the slices end up uneven. You cover your pie to keep it fresh, but the topping comes off. Now there's a solution. Introducing the perfect pie cutter. The same pie cutter used by hundreds of top
What is this? What? Hey, Jerma, since you've been watching infomercials, I thought I could recommend one that's pretty entertaining. When I was about 10 years old, I got cast as Chucky Stewart in an infomercial advertising a product called Sandwich Shapers. It cuts the crust off your sandwich and also turns it like an animal or a fun shape. I got the audition for it through a talent agency. I later found out the commercial had gone national and nobody told me. Are you shitting me, dude? You were Chucky Stewart? I did not see that over here in mod chat. I promise. I just played that. I didn't even know that was here. Really? A viewer here. Was that kid? I don't know if that's fake. I think that's real.
Restaurants across the country.
Maz, is this real or is it a bit? No, it's real. That's apparently real.
Simply push down on the perfect pie cutter and the angle
international star
pie into perfect slices. No more crumbling slices, no more uneven
that's
cuts.
Fucking insane.
With the perfect pie cutter,
that's
you
insane.
Get perfect slices every time.
Ban him.
Now
hold on a minute, guys. I want to make sure that we make this, get, you know, all the facts here. The mods are telling me that was posted yesterday in the Discord. That was posted yesterday. I did not see that. So this is for real. This person's not jumping on the sandwich shaper bandwagon here just because it was on camera. That was in the Discord yesterday. Wow. Actually real. Yeah. Yeah, this is posted yesterday in the Discord.
Have the same secret used
that's
by restaurants in your own home.
What
I love
the
it
fuck?
Because now I can have that look at home with my friends and family. And I'm just like, how do you make everything look so fancy?
That's Chucky Stewart?
And it's the perfect pie cutter.
Tired. I love this shit so
the
much.
Leftover pie running and drying up? Well, not anymore. Leave the perfect pie cutter in your pie.
Actually ban him, though. I'm not going to ban
the edges.
I'm not going to ban the kid. Fresh. Well, I know. I'm not gonna ban that. He's not a kid anymore. Chucky Stewart is like 40 right now. I don't know why. I was imagining like, oh, ban him as a it'd be funny. I'm like, I'm not gonna ban a 10-year-old. Chucky Stewart is like 30. He's 30 or 40 years old. Actually, I would probably ban a 10. Yeah, I would ban a 10-year-old. You're not fucking allowed to be here.
Tired of covering your pie only to have the topping come off when you remove the covering? Well, never again. Just place the plastic wrap over the perfect pie cutter and it won't touch your topping and ruin your pie. Tired of your spatula being the wrong size?
That's so cool, though.
The perfect pie cutter comes with a specially designed spatula that fits perfectly between the blades, so you can serve perfect slices every time. The perfect pie cutter is durable and dishwasher safe. Get ready for the holidays or any special...
All right, I'm done. I've had enough. I'll see you guys later. That's going to conclude the stream. It was a quick one today. Yeah, I know. He actually could be closer to 60. No, he would absolutely not. That commercial was like 1998 or like 2000 or something. 2001. 2002. Yeah, that's it. When's the next stream? Let's see. Today's Tuesday. We could do... Maybe this weekend? Saturday, Sunday? Well, I'm thinking Saturday, Sunday. On the weekend. I think that works. This was 2013. So, okay. So that would be... All right, so... Yeah. So if... If Chucky Stewart was... It'd be like 20? 23? 24? Early 20s? That's so funny. That's such an insane happenstance. All right, I'll see you guys later. Thanks for watching. That was infomercials. Whoops. That's better. Take care of yourself. See you this weekend, Saturday and Sunday. I actually don't have a plan. By the way, that's not the last time you're going to see infomercials. I think we have way too much fun with these. I mean, there are literally thousands and thousands of infomercials. So there's plenty. We should probably take a little bit of a break. Maybe not for a few streams, you won't see it. Just because I don't want to, you know, I want it to be fun and special. I don't want to just have it, just do it every day. Take care. Yeah, take care. All right, let's take a look real quick. Let's do a raid. I want to raid. Stir is live. Vinny's live. There's a bunch of people live right now. I never catch Stir live. But Stir, I mean, his thing, opening up the dump cake and pour, be good, be nice if you're gonna hang out in Stir's chat. He's gonna be very furious with me. Stir's gonna be upset with me that I did this, so. Be nice. Go say hi to Stir. Playing Rogue Legacy 2. If you don't know who Stir is, there's a lot of new viewers here. Let me just explain. If you didn't remember, if you don't catch it, or if you can. Oh, who's that? Stir was in the replacement stream. Obviously, he's one of the judges. Very funny guy. I've known him a long time. just went offline. What? Wait, because I was talking about it? No, he didn't. If he did that, that's really funny. Okay, I'm gonna cancel that. Okay, so... all right. So there's a few other people we could raid. You know, let's let's go say hi to Boxbox. Boxbox is awesome. What's Boxbox doing? What are you up to? Training in Valorant. Valorant training. Yeah, Boxbox is awesome. I got to spend a little time at the Streamer Rewards with Boxbox. Really, really, really swell, swell person. Valorant? He didn't end because of you. He was on an 8.5-hour stream. Oh, okay. All right, good night, guys. See you later. Take care of yourselves. Goodbye. Good night. See you Saturday.